I ain't make no requests, nigga.
I did. I ain't gonna hold y'all there. Look. Coming in with this.
What's that? What is that?
This dance. I couldn't get my arms all the way down.
Look.
Let's go.
Who at that door? Nigga, ask who?
Let me pick one. Duck, goose.
Yeah, I love my sons like I love my gun. Duck hunt too. One. Nigga, ask so. Then ask juice. It's fully K. You drop my two.
What?
It's too damn late. Heard you say my name to that light, so pretty make King. Mass like King, slide through his block, we gon' find King.
Nigga.
I can't miss, aim for the brain till it makes sense.
No.
Better say it, man, probably make sure, sass, don't forget.
Yeah.
Out of turn, put you in the urn, get you missing forgets.
Yeah,
now nah, we gotta let this whole shit rock.
He was no threat.
No,
I stayed box.
I was in that eight.
Fuck it with the eight, nigga, woke me up like fish
a braids. I fixed my braids.
I was thinking good thoughts to the first visit, made a change. My brother died with a pack on him and a strap on him, shit is strange. First thing that I did when I came home, went to the same. Before that, I got brain.
Uh-huh. Yeah,
I did my thing.
Mom's pointing right there, then I looked down.
I can see the stain.
She asked me, do I want his chain?
I ain't say a thing.
Oh,
hurt his ass in the cage, but his little brother be a runaway. It was his book, do he got a gram, nigga, what's his page? His bio say he took a spike, so I had the gunpowder with the sage.
Huh?
Nah. I was so geeked up, tried to put a 50 in a gauge. Got this little thing, I ain't fuck yet, met her in a range.
What else?
Stood up on a side block, gives a pretty ass for the range.
Hmm.
This little goofy nigga must be insane. Had his ass in crown when he with his brown, trying to get some wings. Know what you did last summer, but I'ma make a scream.
That's crazy.
I'ma catch you with your man, yeah, on a sunny day, about the rain. Mm-hmm. Posted like a bum, nigga, asking everybody for some change.
Little
nigga, tell my petty,
I got
your ass heartbreaker, but the game.
Okay.
Old dog had a name, roll for his bro, all cause it came.
Huh?
Old dog had a name, roll for his bro, all cause it came.
Huh?
Nigga, focus on the bitch and he in his phone, he don't see his thing. Should hit him in his back, give it like a push like he on a swing.
That's
your last strike. They gon' give you life with no appeal. No, not tonight. I'ma be alright when I get the deal. Nigga, do you got some change? He said, sorry, nigga, only bills. Scary nigga got the chills. I can feel his breath, cause I'm on his heels. Fast forward to the spark. Switch drip like cock. They can't wait for your waist.
So they had your candle light in the dark.
Free kid be out of jail. He was up a road, couldn't get the bail.
See, this is nah. This is why nigga need a hook. I'm gonna start playing the whole goddamn song.
Yo, y'all think?
Bitch, let it juice.
Drill music is easier to make.
No.
It's harder.
Harder to rap.
It's hard because that beat is hard to catch.
Yeah, hard to catch.
Like it's hard to catch that rhythm.
Mm-hmm. It's actually hard to listen to. Really gay.
Yo, 22. I should have put that. 22 G's got some new shit out.
Oh yeah,
Jesus.
Finally. I'm glad.
Right.
I'm glad.
Matter of fact, let's find.
I'm glad because
I think we good on that.
He was starting to fall off.
Son, he got some new shit out now, but it's like it take a minute for the beat to come in.
Okay,
but when that shit dropped, I was like, God damn, 22.
22 G's was the first hot Brooklyn drill rapper.
Well, he was actually the first one credited with using the UK drill beats.
Yeah, and he made it hot. He did. Gotta give him that.
Is it? Yeah, Twirlanda, that's what it's called.
I spoke to Dirt. That's Rudy Gay. You know what he mean when he said it, right?
That's not what he said.
Yeah, he did.
He said Flop Rudy, because Rudy gave me Flop.
I spoke to Flop. No, it's a nigga. Flock is one of his niggas. Flock. He always saying his name. He said, that's Rudy Gay. That's a shooter. That's Rudy Gay. It took me a while to figure it out.
Durka,
I spoke
Durka,
to Flock.
Durka.
That's Rudy Gay.
K.
I'm the hottest.
What beat is that? That's a Gucci Mane beat.
Oh, you thinking Lemonade?
That is Lemonade.
Oh, it does.
That is
Lemonade.
I love it.
That's 100% Lemonade.
Gang. Slightly different.
Really?
I heard it. Yeah. I hear how you think it.
Cause the name of the song was Twirlanda.
Lemonade was like.
My stepper gon' press him if I press the button too drippy to scuffle.
The whole shit is called Twirlanda.
Blicking the duffel, it came with a muzzle, so why would I touch you?
So when that beat come in, this nigga went crazy.
We don't turn nothing to something. Niggas be capping, bluffing, tweak. That's a hole in your muffin.
Yeah.
What's all attention? Try to run off with the drip, but ain't give me a mention. Switching, we bench him. Trees
at
the drop, we gon' pull up with blickies and drench him. Look at these actors dropping the brakes. Ain't never spin Cali. Spinning for rappers. What's the chances that he got his ratchet?
It's gonna be a disaster. He ain't no step for that boy in a fashion. Stop all that cash.
This is the first one on the album.
In a casket. Gang gang gonna whack. It's on the album.
This trying to get a reaction.
I'm gonna have to quiet
I'm glad.
It got 13 songs on it.
Want me to be disrespectful, pull up to the I just want to hit to that beat dropping. Put some more but you don't see what's coming. See his face, that's for all that
talking. Headshot, he ain't gonna make it. His brains on the pavement, no winners, no statements. My killers ain't taking no payment. They said it's for free.
Yeah, 22.
Gun a nigga down, drop a disc. RP, little pint, pour for that drip. We know run down, go skits. Let my Uda catch him lacking, and ain't hopping out the bed. See all that hate through these Cardis. Call that fresh homo for Cardis.
Hit him, got Cardis on him.
Don't sip no Bacardi. Yeah. Rapper Brooklyn like Biggie and Hardy. Ride that AR with the scope. Pull up the coat. Kill a op to make a toast. Hit an op trees while she dropping the pole. Stuffing the stick in the blizzard.
Watching that came see just like time. Dizzy.
Hoolies gon' spin till he's dizzy. Spider-Man, hop out the prison. Catch a body, then hit up the jeweler. I got 20 blue tips in a Uber. Back then, used to flock out the Uber. Off a scooter. The maneuvers. Can't respond to no nigga that gave his whole crew up. Goofies. Niggas stole all the drip, act like they never knew us. Stole my drip, act like they never knew us. Got a bad yellow bitch that aligned
with Cuba.
Got a bad yellow bitch. She gon' swing me the adder. We pulled up and smoked them like hookah.
This shit is hard as fuck.
Let's go 2-2. Let's go 2-2.
Yeah. That shit, but it take you when that beat come in, like he saw a flow, you like, God damn.
And that's the first song. I want to hear the other.
That's
shit.
The Godfather of Brooklyn Drill right there.
That is hard. Pause.
That's crazy.
God damn, that's hard, son.
Yeah.
Son, it's something about drill, bro. Like
it's something. It's different. Different, son.
The crazy thing about drill is I liked it immediately. Mm-hmm. It wasn't even like it was no hesitation. It was like, all right, I like this.
Yeah.
I'm going to be listening to this for a while.
Mm-hmm. I needed a couple of listens.
Yeah. Really? Oh, yeah, you did.
It's mm-hmm. good, though. We needed a break from trap music. Like,
yeah, exactly.
Everything started
exactly.
And for me, I felt so good about it because I'm from Brooklyn, so it's like, that's even more of a reason. Like, yeah, but if I didn't like it, I wouldn't fuck with
home
it.
Team, right.
I wouldn't fuck with it. Right. But anyway, we back. Welcome back to episode 110.
Hey.
Oh, baby.
Hey.
Of the All Joking Aside podcast, I'm your host, Will Mills, a.k.a. King Dirtbag.
That's him.
A mug bag with the mug rag.
That's him, a.k.a. the baby mama whisperer.
A.k.a. Fat Will Birdo.
A.k.a. Dirt, Dirt, Dirt. A.k.a. Sexpert Dirt Alert.
A.k.a. the baby what?
That's him, the whisperer. We said it already, but that's him. Say it again for the people.
You didn't whisper, though. And sometimes broiled bag. Oh, you in all black today, so you definitely broiled
sure.
today.
Okay.
Well sure. done, bag.
Dressing well all black bag. Like the Omen.
Well, dressing all black like the Omen bag. Omen bag.
Omen.
Omen. Nigga added a bag to the whole sentence, aka Diet Shaft.
Oh,
that's him.
Also, we got my beautiful co-host in the building, Two Chinks, aka motherfucking Chinks Cranon, aka Jigglypuff. AKA Young Cortez.
Okay.
You know what I mean? Chicks always got the fresh feet on. Yeah. AKA Thunder Thighs.
That's me.
She got the Mexican.
I wonder if I can make clap them clap. The wait,
got the Mexican swag today.
Okay. We're looking like a whole AKA essay.
Yeah, right?
That's
AKA
me.
AKA homegirl. The homegirl is abusive.
Selena.
Domestic violence.
AKA Young Orderly. AKA I oh Eileen's. Oh Eileen's. Auto parts.
Ow!
Yo. AKA China Plague. AKA Yinkers. AKA Chinkers.
That's me.
Also, we got my producer slash moderator slash editor of the Old Joker Side podcast, Kwesi, AKA Mr. Gray Area.
That's
AKA
him, that's
Young
him.
Can't Get Right. Grr. AKA Young Yo, Flip Flap.
Bow.
AKA Champion with the Nike. Don't go together. AKA Young Alexander's Dragon.
Oh, party foul.
Party drop.
Not using a mug rag.
Give me the mug rag.
No, right? Not today, buddy. That's a rug. It's going to soak it up. AKA Young.
Give me the rug rag.
AKA Young Clumsy.
AKA Young Tube Socks.
AKA Harold at the Light. AKA Young Harold at the Light. AKA Snaps on the Petrol. If you ate the face ass nigga.
Yo, Snaps on the Petrol.
Why you got to try it?
What's the Snaps on the Petrol? That's crazy.
Pump my shit. AKA Pump my shit.
AKA what you say about my mama?
Nah.
Fact. AKA motherfucking FDK in the building, you know what I mean?
Fake
deep quakes. AKA Smeegeezy, AKA the Smize God of them all, you know what I mean? AKA Slim D's with a porn star.
Make sure.
Make sure you hop in them DMs for the complimentary access to the OnlyFans account.
OnlyFans, baby.
You know what I mean? What's good, everybody? That was a fun little intro.
Yeah. Chilling, Bobby.
Now, don't go somber now.
Huh? Oh, no, we're not going somber.
Thank you.
We ain't got no somber.
Ah, we do got somber news.
Sandwiches. I'm in a good mood, man. You already get...
All right. Okay. Let's keep it
showed
fun.
You already me... ladies getting shot in the head.
All right, fuck it. Let's start out some good shit. All right. Hey, there might be room for us to take over this podcast and shit, y'all.
Woo!
Might be.
There's room.
Let's take the shit over.
Shit died.
Over in JBP world, there's trouble in paradise.
Over?
Oh. Mol and Rory has left the show.
Whoa.
I was gonna send that to the group, but I wanted y'all to hear that from me.
Whoa.
Yeah, it's bad, bro.
Whoa.
Yeah, and Joe said it's a possibility they might not be coming back.
Damn.
Yeah, I'll let y'all hear what he said. Because I don't know if y'all been watching it. What I watch it. I'm a fan.
It's over. I don't want to hear nobody.
Joe
else
can't fucking
by himself.
So I didn't, it sounded regular to me. You know what I mean? But I noticed that I'm going to play with Joe said. Rory, all right, I'm going to tell you, then let him say it. Yeah. Rory been saying, like, yo, I want to throw hands with you. Like, he kept saying that over and over and over again to Joe. You know what I mean? Like, he kept saying it. What? Joe said he said it 6 weeks in a row, like, 6 shows in a row.
Meaning he want to fight him?
Yeah, but if for the listeners, like, that's how they always talk to each other.
Yeah, that's how they always talk, yeah.
Oh.
But for Joe, subliminal. Being friends with him,
yeah, he
kind of like, nah, it's a little different energy.
Yeah.
And also, when I was watching the video, Rory did seem a little edgy. Yeah. Joe, he felt like Joe was playing with him a little too much. You know what I'm saying?
Okay.
So I'll let y'all, I'm going to let y'all let.
Sheesh.
Yeah, bro. A little trouble in paradise in JBP world. Tax Stone in jail. Charlamagne is fucking up.
What else is there?
The nigga, JBP. They the last man standing. Hey, the door's open for all jokes aside right now.
So we just got to kidnap Joe Rogan and we good.
He, that's a different world.
Yeah, we put him in a closet or something.
But fuck that, we coming for him too.
Feed him cereal.
Mike Tyson.
With no milk.
Oh, no, Mike Tyson is lit. All right, here you go.
Right, no
here,
smoke.
Here it is. This is the beginning. This is, gonna bite this, your this ear is what off. Joe said.
No smoke.
This is what Joe said.
I'm getting back in blue.
God damn it.
I knew it.
This is what Joe said, and they're going to play why he's... All right. What the fuck? Hold on. What is going on?
What, Joe the singer?
Oh, no. Hold on.
Wrong
no,
Joe.
It's another, something else playing on here. I'm going to turn it off.
All of the things your man can't do.
They get flagged for some shit he played by accident.
All of the things your
pod. Why is Rowdy Rebel playing?
Your pod can't do.
Nah.
Yeah, there we go. All right. So this is Joe explaining what came, why he made the decision. And then the clip of Rory saying what he said is afterwards.
Right. I get more confused every time he explains it.
I can't allow it. I got to get on top of that. I intervene.
Pause, Joe.
I can't allow it. I got to get on top of that.
Pause.
So when 6 weeks in a row happened of Rory challenging me to a fight and his hands and me not being so comfortable
is he
in
there by
that
because right
I don't necessarily play like that and I'm listening back.
This is Saturday's show, too, by the way.
Okay.
Yeah. And to me, I'm being expressive, saying, yo, man, I don't play like that with my friends. And on the playback, I hear him say, yeah, but what if we're not friends? Whoa, okay. I got to take a look at that.
Okay.
That's for Joe to pause. That ain't for me to think that we in podcast showy, chucky, chucky, ka, kiki, ka, ka, game time.
Let me pause for a second there.
Yeah.
I can really see that Rory wasn't serious and Joe took it that way.
Okay.
I can just see him reacting like that because he's always been a little narcissistic. He's showing it now.
What if he's right, though? What if he's right?
Yeah, but because why would he say, but what if we're not friends?
Yeah, why would he say that?
But they talk like, all right, you're going to hear the clip.
So you think all these years he could take all them jokes and all of a sudden he can't take a joke? Or do you think he feels something different?
Well, I'm Rory's a lot younger than Joe. That's one. And then two, maybe he never was able to take a joke. You know what I mean? Maybe Joe played too. Maybe he feels bullied. You know what I'm saying? You know how niggas know you pussy and you ain't gonna do nothing, so they keep joking anyway?
Mm-hmm.
And, but they know that you don't like it and it gets under your skin, mm-hmm. but they keep going anyway? That's not him not being able to take a joke. That's you being a bully at that point. Mm. Gotta look at it from both sides.
Rory bullying Joe.
No. What I'm saying is Joe's older and a little more aggressive than Rory.
Okay.
So maybe Rory never liked the jokes.
Oh, okay.
Maybe he never liked
the jokes. You're saying Rory been bullied and he just kind of like, fuck that shit now.
Right. It could be that too. But, well, you know what I mean?
I never heard any jokes that, right, that because Rory should have been offended
I never even thought of that until... Because when I look at the playback, I looked at Rory's face. He did look a little bothered. I'm playing.
Mm-hmm.
What if we not friends?
What was the joke?
Excuse me? That's Rory is saying that confidence is being stolen.
All right. So that was the end of him explaining it. Now this is the...
The video.
This is the video.
From his chest.
Yeah, I want to know more about this.
You don't think Rory harbors confidence in his chest?
As hard as there.
Damn, I could easily knock you out. I'm confident about that.
What were they talking about?
Oh, they were talking about fighting. You want to talk about confidence?
They were talking about fighting. That's different.
No, they're not talking about fighting. It went into fighting.
It starts too late then. Because he was saying he harbors confidence in his chest. And then his response was, I'll knock you out. Sounded like they were talking about, what were they talking about? It matters.
They're gonna talk about what they're talking about.
Confidence.
Right here. It comes from right here.
You better stop talking to me with the fiber pills like that. First of all.
Yo, finish the story, yeah, man. I want to know about the cords, man.
I just think it's hilarious that he think a fiber pill don't mean his whole fucking face could get punched in.
I want to know Rory about the Donald's. Rest of the cords. Give me the rest of the cords, man. Tell me about the cords.
Yeah, Mark can feel it, too. Mark can feel
right.
it, too.
But had I not played that Joe clip, you would have just thought this was a regular show. Right?
Nah.
Really?
Nah.
I'm really... I saw this episode. I didn't think nothing.
I didn't see it. I'm really keen on behavior, bro. Like, mm-hmm. I feel the difference. I feel it.
But
like, even the way he said, your whole fucking face. Like, Rory doesn't even speak in that tone.
And then gave the fake giggle afterwards. Yeah. I'm pretty sure they argued after the show.
Okay.
You know what I mean? But let's
My neck didn't actually have anything. Back of my neck had some chakras that were kind of crazy. All
right. At that point, if we're friends...
Yeah.
You sense the aggression with
yeah,
me.
Yeah.
You stop playing with me at that point.
Mm-hmm. Yes, you know what I'm saying? Yes, yes.
That's where Joe's off.
Yeah.
Because just because we friends don't mean you could keep playing with me.
Yeah,
like
I would
that.
Stop. Yeah.
So I would see if he, all right, this nigga's serious. Yeah. Or address the elephant in the room. Address it. Like, yeah. So that is kind of you not being a friend.
Mm.
That's Joe not being a friend because you should know that I'm under. Because, nigga, I know when you mad. You know when I'm mm-hmm. mad. We know each other well enough. We can tell. I can tell when Shanks is.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. It's,
yeah.
Let's take a break. You know what I mean? I can tell. We friends. I've studied my friends. I care about my friends. So if I see one of y'all getting upset, I'm not going to keep going.
Right.
Right.
So if Joe is a real friend, he would sense the agitation and stop.
Yeah.
Or address it.
Mm-hmm. You see what I'm saying? So because clearly Rory's bothered.
This shit could all be a publicity stunt.
I doubt it.
It could be.
If it is, then they
would have been doing it.
I'm not going to erase that. It could be.
I doubt it.
I feel like it could be.
Niggas don't act that good. You ever tried to act?
You know what's crazy though?
It's not that easy.
But it's one of those things where it could have been taken out of context just because of the fact that we don't feel that they have that type
of
conversation.
But I'm gonna tell y'all one thing. I did.
And then let's
though.
Run with it.
Yeah, and they probably was like, "Oh shit, this does seem a little hostile."
No, I'm gonna tell y'all something that Rory has been doing a lot lately. He's been bitching a lot, like complaining about how the other podcasts get. And it sounded like at first it sounded like a joke. But then he said three shows in a row.
The other podcasts get what?
They get more perks than them, saying how they get treated so much better.
Oh, from Joe?
Yeah.
That could be one of those cases where you're already my friend, you're already locked in.
Right.
I'm trying to lock in with them.
But he keeps saying it, though. He said it like three episodes
ago. So, yeah, he probably has some, like...
That shit hit Mal. Like, nigga, you good? Is your ear all right?
Nigga, I heard it. Are you good?
I don't know. Okay. I still can hear.
Okay. All right. Maybe it's your left ear just working.
She got a cool little camera too.
Maybe it's your left ear working.
You gotta add a sound effect into that shit.
Yo,
do I? Because that shit was loud. I don't think I gotta add one.
Shit went bop.
Shit sound like a car crash.
That shit was hilarious, bro.
Damn.
Let's play the rest.
There's more? Okay.
It's a little more, yeah. It's a little more.
I didn't reply to y'all texts when you were talking about the Thursday shit. I was knocked out, and I woke up this morning.
Got you. Okay.
Yeah, I think really Joe thinks this is funny.
No, no, no. I'm going to hear more about it.
This shit was crazy.
No, get to it. I'm
going
to hear it.
Yeah, tell us about the chords. Keep going.
See, Rory's not playing. He said, I see Joe thinks this is funny.
Mm-hmm. I wish I knew what the fuck he was talking about.
He talking about buying something from a liquor store.
Okay. Chords?
Chords.
What the fuck is chords?
I don't know, bro.
Chords sound like music.
Chords of Evil Spirits and Paying a Reader. Oh.
Oh, he's making fun of him because he went to a psychic.
Psychic, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, all right.
So, yeah, that one, and then she tries to release that type of shit. Next one that was in my chest.
No.
Nah,
here comes some Rory bullshit.
Rory might be being a little sensitive. Yeah, I knew this was
gonna be a reaction. I hate this podcast. No one's laughing.
I assumed you guys were gonna laugh.
This is like
I didn't bring this for y'all to understand it.
Burning a candle. I was like, nah, it's religion.
Actually, that adds into more what I'm saying.
You guys, she's one of your cards, though. Rory left.
See Maul. But no, hold on. Maul peeps that Rory is agitated, so he's not laughing.
I get it, but still, it's like
no, but you can't control what a nigga get mad about.
He just said no, you can't. But he just said I came here expecting y'all to laugh at me.
Yeah, I didn't come here for y'all to understand.
Yeah, but the nigga Joe is dying laughing.
He goes, oh, so you want to control how much he laughs?
Bro, you the same way, bro.
How?
It's certain things that I find funny that you don't. Bro, about yourself.
He just said, bro, if I find it funny, if I expect you to find it, doesn't matter if I find it
still
funny. No.
A nigga still get mad.
No, I didn't say he can't get mad. Mm-hmm. I'm just saying, bro, like, this is Joe Budden, bro.
I don't know. It got to be, but that's
what's the difference?
But that's the thing. I don't look at things just from surface level because it got to be more. It's more to it, bro. It got to be. Because Joe said, nigga, 6 weeks in a row of this. Of saying throw it, because this is the isolated incident, of course.
Yeah.
This incident ain't got nothing to do with the past five shows. So he's like, yo, six episodes in a row, like you saying you want to put hands on me. It's a slew of shit at Rory Sigal. If we could find it, well, we don't gotta play this no more. We know.
Can we find the first one?
Right. But I'm not that invested in these niggas. You know what I mean?
Somebody else will do it.
If y'all remember, I called this shit. Months ago.
What? What'd you say?
When Joe made the decision to leave Spotify.
Okay.
And I said, they might have some problems in the future with this.
Mm-hmm.
Because Joe turned down some money. Mm. And now they got to find money. So we're going to see how it works out.
They got the Cash App deal.
Cash App is a sponsor. They can leave it anytime. Cash App don't got to deal with them because Joe Budden is running off the Joe Budden network. Like, he's running off a network.
We don't know the nature of the deal.
But Cash App is a sponsor. They're not a. They don't have a. What? They're sponsors. It's like they sponsor other podcasts. They sponsor like Chris D'Elia's podcast, Joe Rogan. They
My
sponsor.
Point is that they're getting money. You know what
I'm saying? They ain't getting when they getting Spotify. Fuck no. You know what I mean? But the thing about it is, and a Spotify deal was a guaranteed bag. You know what I mean? Like you lock it for a contract, say for seven figures, eight figures. That's a gap for a certain allotted period of time. Like,
so, but how would that tie into them having the problems now?
Yeah, exactly.
Because he walked away from money.
But I feel
like he's good because Joe got other things going on. Hmm. So they may not be cool with that. Because think about it. Maybe I'm worth, like, I probably feel like, yo, I could hold out because I'm good. Like, I'm sitting on a couple of million right now.
But said they was good.
But like I said, we don't know that though.
Yeah.
Joe is good. He's the boss. Like, he's getting the bread. Like, he's good. I'm not saying that's the reason either, because I don't know.
Yeah.
But it's a lot of factors for this nigga to...
It better not be over Joe laughing at that psychic shit.
No, because Joe clearly said before this segment, he said it's been going on for 6 weeks. Yeah. 6 weeks of Rory saying he wanted to put hands on him. And then saying... And I remember the episode we said, what if we're not friends?
Yeah.
He said that. So... Because Joe was like, yo, I'm not, you don't fight your friends after like 25. Like, I don't fight my friends. You don't fight your friends.
Yo, Joe is funny.
Nah, and so. Also, like,
And Rory was like, what if we're not friends?
Yeah, and to make the comment one time, I understand. But to repeatedly make that comment, that's like some...
It'll come out eventually.
subliminal.
So what's going on now? Here's what it says.
Rory's gonna tell us. He's gonna tell us eventually.
Right? Joe Budden did not like Rory constantly challenging him to throw hands for weeks. So Joe made it known that his co-hosts Rory and Maul might not be returning to the show. In one episode,
and why Maul?
That's what I'm saying. This is what makes it even bigger.
I think I'm with you on the Spotify.
You see what I'm saying? Why would they both leave?
That right now.
What the fuck does that got to do with Maul?
With the information that we have, the most likely scenario is the Spotify deal.
Or Joe is taking deals on a personal level that's only benefiting him, and they sitting there waiting on a deal for somebody else.
It sounds like they hating, like on something.
Yeah, I wouldn't say they're hating. I would say he's being a bad boss.
That too, but I would say hating in the sense that they probably don't feel included.
Okay, I get what you mean though. Well, but hating is when like somebody's like doing good or you hating.
Well, like this.
But think about it. They started something together, right?
But they didn't start it together.
Well, but they basically blew up together, right?
They blew up together.
So that's like us blowing up together. Yeah. And me and Kwesi are here doing the same thing. We're with you, even though y'all put in a lot more work, but. Then we see you taking off, and we kind of still in the back.
Yeah.
But that's not y'all hating.
Right.
That's me being a bad fucking leader. Yeah. Because at the end of the day, like, that, I'm glad you said that. That's what I was going to say. Say if I start getting sponsorships and taking sponsorships for the podcast.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I notice when I take sponsorships, I take it for me.
Yeah.
I don't do it for the podcast because that's not fair.
Right.
Like, how I'm going to do that and take all the money for myself? Yeah. So I do a sponsorship. It's for King Dirtbag. It's not for All Jokes Aside.
Right.
Now, anything that goes through All Jokes Aside where there's finances involved, I'm breaking my team off.
Right.
That's only right.
Yeah.
Or investing it back into the show.
Right.
And when that happens, you guys will see it, whether it be equipment or something like that.
Yeah.
So if Joe is taking deals under the umbrella of the Joe Budden podcast, which, by the way, would suck without Rory and Maul.
Facts.
For sure.
A solo podcast.
It's over without them.
Solo podcasts suck in general.
I said this before. Nah, it depends on who you are.
For the most part.
Chris D'Elia and Bill Burr does a real good job of saying about
themselves. They're comedians, though.
Right. That's a fact. So, Joe Budden, which I've said before, they keep him grounded. It's dope. We see him in the light we see him in because of them two.
Yes.
It's the dynamic they have.
Right. We see the friendly side of Joe. Because Joe's an unlikable motherfucker. Like, niggas don't like him. On what was the shit with him in Academics?
Everyday Struggle.
Everyday Struggle. People hated that nigga.
From the clips.
Well, no. I'm
anybody who watches the show,
he was an angry motherfucker on that show, bro.
I disagree, but I think the clips did that. The clips made him look angry.
The shows
that's his style of comedy.
Okay. No. I'm talking about like with the Lil Yachty shit, like that.
He was not angry. He was. Lil Yachty wasn't listening to him.
Okay, it doesn't matter. He don't know how to talk to people.
Okay.
That's what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Maul and Rory forces him to be a different person. Like, he's not like that around them. So he becomes a more likable person with his friends. Like, he's more like affectionate, like a loving dude. Like, he seems a little more intense around Academics or even on the other one with Remy.
Yeah, that's anybody. Though.
Super intense personality.
Yeah.
But on a podcast, it don't flow without them niggas. Mm-hmm. Like, they have to be there.
For sure.
If Maul or Rory or both, if one of them leave that shit,
Joe has to know that, bro.
Because first of all, Maul and Joe together is whack.
Mm-hmm.
Rory and Joe together is whack. That shit is corny.
I like Rory and Joe. At one point, it was
Rory Joe. But you need that. But you need Maul. Like,
could you see Maul and Rory by themselves?
Yes.
It's better.
Yes.
Yikes. That's crazy.
Yes.
But that says a lot.
I could see Maul. Nah. Maul and Rory works.
Nah, because they're too safe. That's where you need Joe. Joe makes them dangerous. Right, Rory and Maul are safe.
They safe, yeah.
See, the podcast.
But I could see them too. Joe by himself.
I can see them working.
Humorous, yeah. They're humorous. Yeah, they would make me laugh, but they're too safe.
They would work.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
They would work. Yeah. I don't think Joe works without them two. And Parks, with his ad-libs in the background.
I've seen Joe do some lives and stuff by himself. And Joe is an interesting guy. But nothing is gonna equate to the dynamic.
Right,
and
nothing.
And Parks.
Yeah, because like, who's gonna challenge Joe and Joe become comfortable enough to be able to combat that?
Right, and to not get like, right, when you challenge Joe, he gets aggressive.
Aggressive.
But when his friends challenge
him, his guard is down.
It's a dope, like me and Kwesi. Remember me and Kwesi a lot of times, when we used to challenge each other, it turned up.
Right.
But the more closer we became, now me and him could turn up on each other, and have the dopest conversation.
No, now we could challenge.
Now we could challenge each other without turning up. Mm-hmm. You see what I'm saying? That's what becoming a friend does.
Right.
When you leave the business aspect of it and put the egos down and be like, oh, this is just my friend I'm talking to. Mm-hmm. Yeah. And we're potting right now.
Yeah.
He does that with them.
Yeah.
I don't know anybody. And I'm probably the closest people. Joe probably ain't got a lot of friends.
Joe just probably doesn't know how to draw that fine line when it comes to like respect. How you, like you said, how he right. talks to people. And right. that can get tiring because people probably feel like, damn, like, we've been in this shit for so long together. You thought, you would think he would know by now.
The shit get annoying.
Yeah.
I'm not riding with that. I'm not blaming Joe for this. I don't have enough information.
Well, we don't know.
Yeah. We don't know.
But my thing is,
it could be his fault.
But my thing is, if Rory and Maul left
that
together.
I don't see,
but remember, Maul is Joe's friend.
Okay.
Right? Mm-hmm. Rory is Joe's friend. Mm-hmm. Maul and Rory together are there because of Joe. Mm-hmm. So if Maul and Rory feel collected on an issue, I got to go to Joe. Like, nigga, what you did, bro?
Well, just because they both left doesn't mean they're collected on the issue. They might have just left at the same time for whatever reason. Doesn't mean that they necessarily...
I honestly...
It's a lot missing here.
Yeah, I honestly want this... That'd be sad.
Yeah, I want
that. That'd be sad because I ain't gonna hold you, nigga.
That is the best
part. I almost shed a tear when them niggas left Spotify. That last show, I was like, this shit is
You really thought it was the last show?
No. The last show, Spotify. That shit was kind of heartbreaking. I'm like, damn, man. I knew
they was coming back, though.
I knew they was coming, but it was a minute. They took a little while.
Yeah,
it took a little while. But
interesting.
But... Shout out to them, you know.
Best of luck.
Yeah, best of luck. I really hope they.
Those are the trailblazers for urban podcasts, so we don't want you right. to.
I really definitely hope they get their shit
keep
together.
It going.
Yeah. And we talked too long about them niggas, too. But
nah, man, that was good.
Yeah, salute to them. But yeah.
There's more Trulies?
Yes. All right.
Finna get drunk on the Trulies.
What do we have next on the D Knock It?
What you got on the Drrr?
We got a bunch of. Okay, let's get into a little sports here. Let's rush through this little sports. Oh, no, fuck that. Let's keep it on social media. Your boy Trump is gearing up to start his own social media platform.
Bruh.
I'm here for it.
There's a name for it?
What's the name? I'm curious.
I don't think they have one yet. Let me see. They didn't say. They said he's actually trying to start his own. Trump social media platform.
I guess.
I don't know what it's called. Trump in talks. Here we go. Here we go. Former President Trump. God damn it. Former President Trump is reportedly in talks with multiple apps to partner with them in order to create his own social media network. Axios, citing multiple sources familiar with the situation, reported Wednesday that Free Space, a new social media platform, is one of the top contenders for Trump and his social media advisor Dan Scavino. The platform wants its users to share content that will add value to their lives and model healthy habits for others to duplicate. The Free Space actions are backed by science to positively reinforce good habits and make the world a better place.
What?
Free Space's platform says Free Space has only 20,000 downloads so far from the App Store and Google Play Store. The app went up. I guess I don't care.
He trying to stay relevant?
Or what does it say? Jared Kushner, Trump's son-in-law and former senior advisor, reportedly convinced him not to join social platforms Parler and Gab after he was banned from Twitter earlier this year.
I was just about to say.
Okay. What y'all think about that?
I think he's trying to stay relevant.
You know what I don't like about Trump supporters? I was talking to somebody about this earlier, and they were saying how they hate somebody, and they didn't want to speak to him. And I was like, I would 100% have a person like who we going to talk with, Derek Jackson, for instance. I would love to have him on my platform. That's what makes Derek Jackson so whack to me. And a person like him doesn't want to talk to the ops. He want to talk to people who agree with him.
Right, right.
That's cowardly shit. Mm-hmm. You should talk to your opposition at all times.
He preys on his audience.
Right. Yeah. But what I'm saying is, like, Trump... social media platform is how could you improve on anything if you're only talking to people who agree with you?
Right.
How do you even know what the problems are? Like,
right.
And that's,
who said it's going to be a space for people who agree with each other?
What I'm saying is Trump's platform, for instance, they're creating it because Trump was banned from mad social media platforms. Mm-hmm. And a lot of his supporters were banned from social media platforms.
Wait, are you assuming that?
They were.
No, no, you're assuming that they're making it because Trump got banned.
I'm saying it's based off of how Trump supporters work and people who believe, who follow Trump.
But you know, that's different from saying this is why they made it.
I'm not saying that's why they made it.
Okay.
But what I'm saying is it's safe to assume that Trump supporters are very tight-knit and they stick together.
Yes.
So if Trump creates a social media platform, I can see, of course, his supporters flocking there. But you also have to welcome the opposition.
Yeah, I was about to say, yeah, Trump haters are going to go there too.
Right, but I don't see them staying. I don't see them having a healthy dialogue because I don't get the point.
No.
You see what I'm saying?
So what is it going to be? On there slandering?
You could do what you want.
But real talk, like, that's all from what I see now. It's like, now that Trump is gone, you still got his supporters out here, right? That's cool.
Going in.
Yeah, that's cool. But now you can ask them, what's your point? Mm. What do you want? It's a new president. You know, and this is fucked up to say, you have to support your president. You should want your president to do well. So it shouldn't be, oh, fuck him.
Wanting your president to do well is not the same as supporting them. Because if I disagree with what you're doing, I don't have to support it.
Bro, they were rallying against this man. And the same thing happened to Trump.
Yeah, that's politics.
Right, but there wasn't a slew of Hillary supporters after Trump won. Kind of like, all right, Trump won.
He got it.
You got it.
What do you mean a slew of Hillary supporters?
All right, if I go out to the corner, like during the campaigning, right?
The whole 4 years of Trump's first 4 years,
right?
It never ended. The Trump hate, it never hated.
Right.
My family personally never stopped talking about him. The whole 4 years, every year in Christmas, when I go to West Palm, my family. I would literally ask my family, "Yo, can we eat without talking about Trump, y'all?"
Mm.
That's cool.
Like,
but what I'm saying is,
yeah,
I could see why people never wanted to give Trump a shot.
Okay,
I could see why. Like, you know what I mean? Okay. You know why I stand it on Trump? As far as it kind of, I think he was just a bad leader. Like, and that's fine to think that.
Uh-huh.
However, now that he's out of office, it's still MAGA hats walking around the street. It's like, yo, he's not even there anymore. Y'all still.
Well, it represents, but now it's not just Trump. Like, it represents an ideology. So right. The ideology is not going to end.
I
tried to explain it in here one day. You got mad at me.
No, because the ideology, you can't make it make sense to me because it makes no sense.
What do you mean? What is it? Remember we was in there talking about the Proud Boys and I told you I went and looked up their shit and you got mad because I said it wasn't racist? Remember? Like, okay. I looked up their shit, bro. It's literally the same shit we talk about. That's
okay, that's fine. So they must be talking about that shit on the low then.
No, it's, what do you mean on the low? It's, okay, if you say on the low, then right. I'm assuming you mean what you hear. All right, so on the low as opposed to what? Social media? As opposed to what? What would be on the high?
The high is just fuck Biden. They're trying to steal the country from us.
Stop right there. What does that mean?
Okay, but how does that help anybody?
Bruh, it depends. What do you mean? It depends on what. All right, he said they're trying to steal the country from us.
Right.
What does that mean?
Okay, my thing is, my that's fine.
This is the same discussion that we just had last week about transphobia. Where does that come from? Just earlier today when you said you spoke to the girl who you made the meme, and she was a stud, and I was like, wait till she sees our shit. And what did you say? She ain't no liberal PC nigga.
Yeah, right. Right. Okay, I don't think you get what I'm saying. What I'm saying is,
how does it help?
All right, you're being anti-establishment. They're anti-establishment, right? Being anti-establishment doesn't help.
I think they're anti-New World Order.
But that's a conspiracy theory.
No, it's not. It's not a conspiracy theory. George Bush Sr. announced the shit in 1989. It's not a conspiracy theory. That's never been a conspiracy theory.
I don't believe in a New World Order. I don't believe in a New World Order?
What's the New World Order?
This nigga like the... How do we get here? I don't even know what the original
because
conversation
was about. Because you said...
Right, please,
I'll bring it back for you.
You took me like...
No, I didn't take you anywhere.
Yeah, you really did, bro. No, I didn't take myself there.
No, I did it. You said, bro...
We're talking about... No.
You said... Watch this. I got you. You said, how do we get there? I'll show you right now. You said when Trump got elected,
right.
Hillary God fans... You said Hillary supporters right. shut the fuck up, right? But I showed you that they actually did.
Right, but Quasi, before I can even make my point, you changed the what? Subject. Like, so we're no longer talking about what I'm talking about.
So what point
about.
Are you making?
I have no idea what I'm talking about anymore. Please bring me back.
What,
I don't even remember what my point was because I didn't want to go here. Like
you said, if they have an established, if they have a social media platform, right? You said you don't see how.
Oh, okay, we're talking about Sean.
Yeah, right. Trust me, bro. I'm on point. Okay. You said you don't see how it's going to be productive. And I was like, well, what's the argument you think they're going to have? And then you said they have a stupid argument. And I was like, what is their argument? You get what I'm saying? So what I was saying to you basically was, it sounded like you were saying they should stop following Trump because he's not in office.
I didn't say that.
Well, you said they should stop speaking on it because he's not in office.
I didn't say that either.
Well, you said something in the sense of like why are they still going? He's out of office. They need to support the new guy, right? You said that, right?
And I was saying, my point was,
yeah,
none of this shit because I'm not trying to prove my point on any of this. My point was. God damn it, this nigga fucking... My point was... No, you really did. No, I'm not... I keep bringing it back to what you said, though. But I didn't get to finish before you did that.
Did what? I was reacting to what you said. But when I repeat what you said that's not what you said. You did say that. You said their argument is going to be stupid.
Right.
They need to shut up because Trump is gone. They need to support the new guy. And then what I said was...
Right there is
where the point is. Because...
How are you telling me my point?
No. I'm saying what I said. You stopped me right there. I'm trying to show you why we got here. So when you said they need to support the new guy, I said it's not about Trump. It's an ideology. Then you said, what's the ideology? Then right. I started explaining.
Right.
So what I'm saying is the reason they're not shutting up is because they still have an ideology that applies to what's going on right now. That's what I'm saying.
And I'm confused.
You said that the platform is stupid because they're going to be opposed. They're not going to... When they should be open to other people coming in,
right.
and they should support their new president. And I said, it's not about Biden versus Trump. It's an ideology. It's what you said earlier. You said it's the...
It's the liberal PC versus
the new world order, which you says doesn't exist, which it actually does.
No, it doesn't.
Okay, bro. What is the new world
order? It's a conspiracy theory, bro.
Bro, you don't even... What is it?
It is a conspiracy theory. No, but is it a conspiracy theory?
No, it's not.
Why is it not?
A conspiracy theory is a theory based on an idea of people conspiring.
Right.
So what does that mean? So everything is a conspiracy theory.
Everything's not a conspiracy theory because some things are factual. Conspiracy theories aren't factual.
Bro.
They aren't factual.
George Bush Sr., President of the United States, 1989, announced the New World Order. Facts.
What's the New World Order, Kwesi?
The New World Order is to make a global economy... Right, to make it to where it clamps down on freedom, based on bringing like minded nations together, to clamp down on the citizens. Global government, and that's literally happening. There are people pushing, but it's not a secret. It's not a secret. Like people are pushing for this global government, a global dollar, a global everything. So when we're watching videos. Of the tunnel thing, connecting those European countries.
Right.
Remember the UK? Remember how they conjoined those European countries?
Right.
United Kingdom. They're trying to make North America one big. They're trying to connect Mexico and everything. All of that.
That already is though.
Okay. Then. So why are you saying it doesn't exist? It was announced in the
80s. No. But that's been like that since like the 1800s.
No, bro.
North America, Canada, and U.S. is not the North. Is not North America.
They're trying to make a $1, bro. They're trying to make.
Oh, you said a currency.
Yes, global. Yeah, but that's just one part of it. They're trying to make a global government, bro. That's happening. That's literally happening.
Okay.
But yeah, that's all. That's all I'm saying.
You do know you changed the subject, though, right?
What did I change it to?
Because I was talking about a social media platform.
What was your problem with the social media platform?
My problem with the social media platform is from what I see from Trump supporters.
And you said it earlier.
I actually don't have a problem with the social media platform.
Would you hear? He said, real talk. What did you hear when he said he had a problem with it?
Can I ask you a question, Chinks?
You what?
Did he take it somewhere else?
Did you hear what his problem was?
I feel like I understand what he was trying to say, and I understand how you.
I responded directly to what he said.
To what he said.
I don't change subjects, bro.
No, okay. But I didn't ask a question,
bro. Plot twist.
Oh, so I can't speak.
Oh. Let's get into something.
Joe and Rory.
Why would he say
Joe and Rory?
Why would he tell me that he didn't ask me a question? That's like, nigga, what are you speaking for?
Because when I'm making a statement, right, I have to put a period at the end of it before you respond, and I wasn't able to do that.
Okay.
So now I got lost.
So you didn't make a statement about what your problem was.
But I wasn't while I was talking. Yeah. You can play it back. No, listen. Mid sentence, you stopped me and changed what I was saying. Nah. You did that.
I can't wait to watch it back.
Dirt Budden and Croy.
No. I swear to God, I wasn't finished what I was saying. You stopped me. He's like, that's not true. Like when you did that, it threw me off.
What did I say wasn't true?
It doesn't matter. Are you? That's what you did though.
So what if
you did that? I didn't get the finish.
No, watch it back.
Don't do the condescending thing. You did that for
real. Not being condescending. Disagree with you. Condescending. I'm not being.
I said
directly disagreeing.
I said something that you didn't agree with, and you stopped me before I finished.
Okay.
You know what I mean? So when you did that, I didn't get the. I forgot what the fuck I was talking about, and we could be because when you did that, we wind up going somewhere else.
I'll take your word for it. But you were definitely talking about what your problem was with it, and you said.
But the point was, I wasn't finished.
Okay.
I didn't get to make my point before you responded. You know what I mean?
I didn't expect it to go. I didn't expect it to go that far.
I didn't expect you to change the subject.
I've never changed the subject on the show ever.
Okay. Watch this.
I didn't change the subject.
Watch this. I didn't take it to conspiracy theory. I was talking about a social media platform.
I didn't take it to a conspiracy theory.
Yes, you did.
You call it a conspiracy theory. I'm telling you what these supporters and what their problem is. You said that they need to shut up because Biden is in office. I'm telling you why they still talk.
The point of the matter.
That's why.
The point of the matter is I was talking about Trump's social media platform. Yes. And you started
talking about your problem with it.
Let me finish. You're doing it again. You're doing it again.
Okay, Dirk.
I was talking about social media platform. Before I could finish talking about my gripe or whatever I agree with it, you took it somewhere else. So we didn't even get to finish the conversation about the social media platform before we went somewhere else.
I was talking about what they're arguing, what the issue would be, the clash would be in the social media. That's what you were talking about, bro.
No, I was talking about social media platform, period.
Bro, you were talking about what the clash would be. You literally was talking about
I got it. I got what I was talking about on the docket. I wouldn't have brought that up. Like, I wouldn't have just done that.
We're just going to play it back. I know what you said, bro. You said it's going to be stupid because they're not going to be open to people outside of Trump support. And then you said, what's their argument? And then I told you what their argument was. That's all I did.
That's fine.
It's not a conspiracy theory. I'm telling you what their argument is. What?
Well, you talking to a person who has to be right.
Like, it's not about being right. I'm telling you what I said.
I'm talking about having a conversation, right? When people are having a conversation, the person completes their sentence or their point, and then you make your point. No, let me finish. You keep cutting me off every time. I don't get to finish. You can't respond just because you don't agree. Let me finish first and then make your point. That's a conversation. It's not a conversation if you're interjecting in the middle of my point.
Thanks, sir.
Right?
Mm-hmm.
That's what you did.
Yeah.
God damn it. Now we're talking about something else. What are we going to now?
Imagine if Trump had a podcast.
I don't see why he doesn't have one.
I would see that would take off.
Him and Candace Owens.
Oh, wow.
I thought that'd be funny.
All right, watch this. Would he smarten up or would she have to dumb down?
He would have to smarten up.
They would both be exactly the way they are, and it would be funny.
You know what? Candace Owens is so transparent. Like, what?
Not
transparent. What's the word? Because remember when she had recipes?
She's direct?
No. She's so brilliant that she knows how to level down while still... Because King Face, rest in peace, she didn't sound that... She kind of dumbed down her usual stuff when he was on her show.
He's pretty articulate, though.
No, he speaks well. He's not articulate.
But he comes from an urban...
Right. But Candace...
Simple.
Candace is... what's the word? She's...
Academic?
Not flexible. What's the word?
Versatile?
Versatile.
Okay.
She's versatile.
Okay.
So I can see her sitting with Trump and making him smarter.
Yes.
You know what I mean? Yeah, she knows how to make... I can see her doing
it. I think
that.
It will work.
I don't know. That'd be kind of dope, though. I would watch that shit.
It's interesting dynamic.
Candace and Donald Trump?
Yeah, that's dope.
Bro.
Political podcast.
I'm tuned in all day.
Black, young black woman, old white man.
It's talking just, politics. It's a lot,
yeah, or just whatever.
Or whatever.
I don't think they'd be talking about it. I think politics would be like the minimum.
The last thing
they're
talking
about. Yeah, I think last thing they're talking about.
I don't know.
I don't even think Trump is into politics.
He never was.
But
that's
she would want to test his intelligence. When it comes to that.
I don't think she would test him because she knows that he's not a politician.
I still think she would test him because I feel like she's a type to, like, she likes to feel smarter than others.
By default, she would test him, I think.
Yeah.
By the way she talks.
Right.
I would like to see that.
That'd be fire.
All right, speaking of matchups coming up, next versus The last one, I don't know if y'all, I watched because I'm a fan. It was, but see, I was telling people that the reason why I didn't get the views they thought it would because Apple no longer owns Versus. It's on Triller now. They sold it. You know that? Did y'all know that?
No.
I didn't know that?
Triller?
Swizz Beatz.
Triller?
Yeah, they building it up, I guess. That, the fight's been on, the last Tyson fight was on Triller.
Yeah. Okay.
So
okay,
Triller's
okay,
coming
okay.
up.
Okay. Yeah.
So
that's right.
That's why the views was like 90 something thousand.
That was the video app thing, right?
Triller.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. It's the same Triller. They move it to TV now. Interesting. So Triller's coming up. Triller's coming up, and they're doing some big things. So they got Versus now. Swizz Beatz and Timbaland sold it to Triller.
Is Triller black owned?
I doubt it. Highly doubt it. That's probably some venture capitalists grouped together and bought that shit. And to be making the moves they making. I know Swiss and Timbaland had to get the bag for that.
Yeah. You know why I didn't watch Raekwon and Ghost?
I didn't like the matches, to be honest. I thought it was a little disrespectful.
All the best songs are together.
Right. And they did a lot of that.
What are we doing?
They did a lot of that. A lot of
Who's
it.
Who's next? Red and Meth?
They should have had, they said they didn't want to do like Ghost and Ray versus Mobb Deep would have been fucking crazy.
Oh, yeah.
But you'd have had Havoc. Yeah, but I know Prodigy got kids. Bring a son or why? And how is that disrespectful? I think that's honor.
It's not disrespectful.
I still think that's honoring him.
It's not fair.
Mobb Deep?
No, it's not fair because Prodigy is the personality. So yeah. Havoc is boring.
I think Prodigy
just be like,
rest in peace. Prodigy, they both boring.
No.
Yeah.
They both boring.
No. Prodigy's boring, bro.
I disagree.
He's the rapper. They both had the same exact personality, bro. Actually, I would argue that Havoc probably had more personality than Prodigy. Hmm. Prodigy was real calm and like, he wasn't.
Neither of them are really charismatic to me.
Neither one of them.
Yeah.
I agree. I would agree.
Yeah, I think they had the same energy. Mm-hmm. I thought that would have been kind of respectful to have a Mobb Deep. Versus somebody seeing
it. Without him being there?
Yeah. I think you should pay homage to him. Just don't do it.
Is there another two?
Capone Noriega.
See, that's like
Mobb Deep could put them niggas in the wash cycle though.
I don't know who I don't know who said it, but somebody said Versus needs to start having openers.
Yeah, Joe said that. On Joe Budden show.
Like five
or five. Like a halftime show.
Yeah. So now with that. A Ghost and Ray versus who did we just say?
Mobb Deep is a 20 song.
I'm just saying, but that don't mean they can't.
Oh, Mobb Deep G Unit, but 50 wouldn't agree to that.
I think once they finish like all the old school.
I think Mobb Deep would finish. I think Mobb Deep would get G Unit the fuck out of here.
No, it's what Dipset G Unit, but would you?
Dipset G Unit, facts.
Yeah.
So who would Mobb Deep go against?
Capone and Noriega.
Mobb Deep and Ghostface and Ray is perfect. I just don't like it because Prodigy's not here.
Okay.
It's weird.
I think.
But I'm sorry. But what was dope though? Old Dirty Bastard's son came out.
Yeah.
Nigga looked just like him, son. Had the same braids and everything. That was dope.
He did his verse.
Nah, he just came out and said what up. But they did bring the Genius came out and did a verse.
Okay.
And Master Killer came out and RZA came out. They all was there.
What did they do?
RZA came out to say like.
Did they do Winter Wars?
Yes.
With Cass? What am I bugging out?
With Master Killer?
No, Winter Wars.
Are you talking about Capadonna?
Capadonna.
No. They did Run, but Capadonna wasn't on it. They did, was it Ice Cream? Like Chocolate Gore wanted to say. No, they didn't. No, Capadonna wasn't there.
Okay.
They did one with Master Killer and one with GZA.
Okay.
My bad, Chanks. I'm sorry.
Well, I wanna see them put out new artists. Because they doing like old school. They doing like old school hip hop. Like, I get it. But when it comes to new school, who you think are the first people they're going to put out?
Oh, Versus you're talking about.
Yeah.
Lil Baby.
Lil Baby. Now he's still,
but see, remember, you got artists that's new, but not new.
Right.
Like, you got like 21 Savage is new, but he's not like new. You see what I'm saying? Lil Baby's still too new.
I feel like they would have to do freestyle battles because you can't do it. I don't know who to put together.
You talking about new rappers?
Yeah, because
Kendrick versus Drake.
Not nah, see,
no, no, no. Kendrick would be against.
Sorry, Kendrick versus J. Cole.
Hell yeah,
right?
Would be good.
Hell yeah, you have to do Drake versus Kanye some shit. That's too
facts,
good.
Facts.
You got to do like you got to do that. You can't.
Yeah, he's like final boss type shit.
Somebody, oh, matter of fact, Lil Duval posted this. I'll talk about it. Lil Duval said the only person who could beat Michael Jackson in the verses, I mean, to beat Usher, to beat Chris Brown in the verses is R. Kelly. Cat, we talked about this. Usher will finish Chris Brown off.
Facts.
Charlamagne said Chris Brown got more joints, but Usher got the nuclear bombs.
I said that.
No, I know what you said. That's why I'm bringing it up. He's agreeing with you, but he specifically said
I said nuclear Usher, bombs. Usher, Chris Brown makes hits. Usher makes classics.
Yeah.
Classics is you get... Usher is makes smashes like,
and Chris Brown is more pop than R&B to me. We did this.
Yeah, Usher has way more. I mean, Chris Brown has way more music than Usher.
Yeah,
and way more
versatility.
But
yeah, Timbaland is caught up.
Anything on. Usher drops, anything is same right there. Mm. Chris Brown's songs don't have that replay value.
Maybe they should do a producer versus.
They did that.
That's how it started.
That's how it started.
But like the new. You know, with the new age, because that would narrow
Mike
down.
Will, like, what's the nigga name?
Mike Will. You got your boy, Metro.
Metro.
Metro Boomin. Metro Boomin.
The one that did the shit for the drill music. What's his name?
Axel.
And
he might be a little too new.
Nah, who else they could use? What's the fat nigga name?
Young Chop. He got up out of here real quick though. He did a couple Chief Keefs, a couple. Hits and then he was out of here.
No. He got more. He did other shit too. That's big that we didn't know about.
Yeah, sure.
He changed his style up a little bit. Is he in jail?
I don't know why.
He in jail, right?
He was wilding out
on Instagram, and I know he got locked up. Did he ever get out?
I don't know. I ain't seen him. Damn.
But next verses, they got it out. Mm-hmm. Fucking Escape versus SWV. That's fire.
Is it not 20?
I can hardly speak.
Not you sure.
20. Not for SWV.
They got a double.
20.
For the real fans.
They don't got 10.
They got a... Nah, you bugging, my nigga.
I don't do that real fan shit. For me, versus...
That matters.
Versus is hits for me.
But see, it's been... It'll be another... Escape don't got 20 either.
That's what I just said.
So, I mean, it's for more of the fan.
You know,
whenever... So we come there for the 10, though. Right. We come there for the joints. Right. You know what I mean?
Right.
So we're going to get at least a good 9 that we know.
Yeah.
And the rest are gonna be like, what the fuck? Well,
you know how I do. When they announce verses, I always go, do they got 20? That's my first question. Mm-hmm. Always, do they got 20? Because what we doing here? I don't think Escape, I don't think they got 20. So.
Escape, neither one of them do.
Neither one of them.
They don't got 20 hits for sure.
We gotta do openers, man.
Mm-hmm.
Escape and SWV is 5-on-5. 5-on-5. So. I'm not saying they don't have 10, 15, but 5-on-5. That's a good.
Who wins a 5-on-5 between them two?
Escape, because they got the joint with. Escape wins. They got the joint with Mariah.
I say the same thing.
They got Escape bigger wins. Records. Bigger records.
Escape wins.
But SWV might have the biggest record out of both
anything?
Groups.
Week.
Anything.
No.
Anything.
No, right here.
Oh yeah. Ooh.
With the
Michael Jackson beat, yeah.
And they got anything was hard, too.
Yeah, I don't think
ODB.
I don't think SWV got anything for that. Only SWV, their biggest
Escape
song.
Escape don't got nothing.
Sorry, Escape got the song with Mariah. What's the Mariah joint they got?
They had a joint with Mariah?
Yeah. Escape got a song with Mariah. Jermaine Dupri put them on the remix.
Oh, they got Rain. SWV got Rain.
Look up Mariah and
Escape.
Matter of fact, give me 10 seconds of that. Well, if you feel
Escape
like
Mariah.
Yeah.
I'll put it in.
It's a slow song. It's slow. And the video is them in the studio making the song. They actually use the studio footage in the video. Mariah, that's like their biggest record. It almost came to me. You'll Always Be My Baby.
They are on that one.
Yeah, You'll Always Be My Baby, yeah.
Doo-doo-doo. Yeah, they are.
It would be that versus...
SWV
versus
right got...
And that's actually Mariah Carey's song.
I know. Yeah. But they could do it in verses. They could do it.
What do?
Yeah. That's why I was saying they don't really got one. That's their biggest shit right there. It's that shit, boy.
This was, I didn't like this one. I like the regular one better.
Oh, okay. That's good.
I like the original.
The original one is way better.
Nah.
Son, what's going on with me?
Yeah, SWV got I'm So Into You right here.
Ooh, I forgot about I'm So Into You.
Mm-hmm. Oh, no, Escape got a couple. They got Understanding.
All Night Long.
Need From You. They got Who Can I Run To?
Who Can I Run To?
That might be my favorite.
Crazy. That might be my favorite. Just Kicking It.
Ooh, just
kick up your shoes and relax your feet. Ooh. Party on down to the S. That's a great battle,
bro. But they should be doing 10, though, not 20.
Oh, now the arms of the one who loves you.
Yeah,
that one is hard. They got a lot of son, My Little Secret, bro.
Oh, yeah. Oh, wow.
Hold on. SWV got Escape?
Nah,
I'm going through their shit. Hold on, wait a minute.
It's getting
crazy.
Tonight,
name the SWV. Ooh.
Nah, I don't know if that's where you got Escape, bro.
You know why, though? They got the better producer. They got Jermaine, man.
Yo, I don't know if SWV could get Escape.
Nah, it's sounding crazy now. I ain't gonna lie.
Yeah, I'm looking at this
because you just named some shit.
Softest Place on Earth.
I don't know that.
What?
You talking about pussy?
Son, that was my shit. Nigga,
they gotta be talking
son.
About. They gotta be talking about.
He's talking about pussy.
Take you on a fantasy. Yeah, something. Then my song did. Remember that song,
Shane? Oh, nah, I never heard.
Let me see.
Yes, you did. Take you on a fantasy.
That was your little personal little freak song.
Nigga, son, watch. You gonna smack yourself when you hear the song.
It sounds familiar already.
So you know the song, son.
That sounds like a dope sample.
Ooh, this is that shit. Hold on, I gotta. This was that shit. Shane, you don't remember this? Watch, Shane. Watch crazy. Here we go.
It's a glowing winter feeling, like a summer sun that slowly rises.
Son, this is the
That big girl from Escape is singing her ass off.
You know what's funny? She's the skinny one now. And the other one is big.
Oh,
yeah, LaToya is the fat bitch. She's...
The fat bitch.
Candy's still bad, though. Candy was always the baddest, and she's still the baddest.
Freak, too.
Super freak. God. Super freak. I want y'all to hear the hug. When you hear the hug, you're going to be like, I remember this song. Here we go.
Okay, yeah.
Candy can't sing, though. Do you want to ride?
She's a writer.
Do you want to ride?
She's a writer.
Deep-ass voice. Do you want to ride? Take you on a ride? Sound like me and shit. Here we go. Turn it up. Here we go. I take you on a fantasy ride. Remember this shit? Don't do my universe. My love's the softest place on earth.
That's going to be a fire version.
Escape got it.
I'm going with
Escape is getting SUV the fuck out of here.
Yeah.
Facts. All right, that was fun.
Yeah.
All right.
We had a verse now.
Oh, okay, word. Okay. That's what I saw earlier. Remember I said I'm going to tell you when you bring it up?
Yeah.
So, Trina is saying that she wants to take on Little Kim in verses.
Trina, all you got is that red bottom.
And I'm telling you with my brother on the phone, when I beat you on power,
you
on the bed, nigga.
Why
is she out of her fucking mind?
Blood clot mind.
Is she out of her fucking mind?
She said she gonna play whoop whoop.
Stop. Pull over that ass too fast.
Son.
Long heels, red bottom.
So hold on, son. Is she disrespecting like
yo,
that?
Yo, dream. First of all, dreams of fucking an R&B dick is gonna murder.
I'm single again. That's all she got, right?
Nah,
that's
true. That ain't even a hit.
Trina didn't say that, son.
She got pull over that ass too fat. She got look back at it, and she got her verse from there, nigga.
Son, Trina is out of her fucking mind, son.
That's it.
What's wrong with her, son?
That's she it. Trying to lose.
Oh, and her verse.
Is she crazy, son?
I am I a baby. What's that song?
Trina done lost her motherfucking mind, son.
What's the Trick Daddy song?
Man, nigga.
No, the one where they're in the basketball courts and shit. Nah. Son. That's what you
mean? Talking to Trina. Shut up, bitch. Nah, this ain't this nigga. Watch. Trina, you don't want no fucking smoke. Are you kidding me? This is Brooklyn's own. You kidding me, yo?
I come from Bed-Stuy.
Kim is gonna kill that bitch, man. What the fuck is wrong with Trina? Fuck out of here. is out of her fucking mind, bro.
Can I get what's that joint?
What?
Play Don't Want Dick Tonight real quick.
I don't want dick tonight.
Lil' Kim was way too plugged in for her to even try to go against somebody like that.
First of all, she's the blueprint for
sexy female rapper, strong sexual
female rapper, confident she is the first female ever. Yeah, to kick it like
ever.
That.
I don't. There's no arguments. Kim is the first
to be sexy. Female. Yeah,
right. The other one was hard. MC Light, Queen Latifah. Salute to them.
Lady of Rage.
But Kim.
Yeah. And she was still hard.
Right. Still hard. Right. Still was a goon.
She wasn't like a.
She wasn't no pussy bitch. Right. Yeah. She was an essential Brooklyn chick. Yeah. Essential Brooklyn New York.
Remember Magic Stick?
Oh yeah, that was good.
Right, that's getting played.
That was good, yeah.
She gonna run circles around. She make a sense. It's gonna be like 18 to 2.
This shit is different. This shit is different. Think you ever heard this?
The bust all in me.
My bad.
Son,
he's at my bad, bitch.
Knew a dude named Jimmy. There's a nut all in me.
Yeah, like, how you start like
look
that?
Look at the first bar, son. Trina, get the fuck out of here.
Yo, you know who reminds me of her? Meg Thee Stallion.
Trina, get the fuck. Everybody reminds
you
of Kim.
Everybody reminds me. Yeah, Nikki, right,
they all. They everybody. All salute Kim.
City Girls, Trina, all of them.
As a matter of fact, that's probably the only person who could step in the ring with Kim is Nikki.
Facts.
She out of her fucking mind, yo.
Yeah, it's only Nikki.
What's wrong with you? Come on, Trina. And I'm telling you with my brother on the phone, when I beat you on Paru, you going to bed, nigga.
Hey, fuck out of here. They line it up with blood.
Line it up with blood, son.
Nigga, you's a bitch.
Fuck out of here.
Yeah, that's wild.
That's crazy, son. Kim should accept that shit immediately.
Do Trina got five?
No.
She got three. If she got five, let me know.
Then go home.
You looking it up?
She ain't got no five. I already did. I stopped that too.
Fellow Miami native?
Yeah, no. Trina. I mean, I never really liked Trina like... I mean, I never really liked Trina like that. Anyway,
Trina top songs. The baddest bitch.
I'm the bad.
Here we go with Kelly Rowland.
Here we go. Here we go again.
Trash.
Now you telling me that she was just.
Single Again. Yeah. Single Again was a hit.
How'd I go?
I'm singing again.
That was
back on the prowl.
Yeah, Trina.
Okay.
Long Heels and Red Bottoms.
I've been saying
long
that.
Long Heels, Red Bottoms. That's Trina.
Step.
Okay, watch this. Some of her verse.
No.
Oh, no, hold on. Pull over that ass too fat.
Yeah, I said that. Woo. I said
that was hard.
That's probably number two. Number one is Nan Nigga. I don't care what nobody says. That's number one.
Oh, for sure. That's
even though it ain't her shit, but she made that song. She made that song.
I'm a Trick Daddy verse on a.
Oh,
Scar.
Shut up. Bam, 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 bam.
Oh, yeah. Fuck boy.
Shut up. Uh-huh. Okay.
Hey,
what's up?
Shut up.
Yeah. She on that?
Yeah.
I'm a Trick Daddy verse on Scar. Remember the first song Trick Daddy ever was on?
Cat Be Coming.
Scar.
Cat Be Coming. Right.
Right. Mike, you remember December last year? I'm a nigga the best year. He was looking at
his. No. But he bodied that. He bodied that.
She was on 5-Star, right? That with Gucci.
She was on 5-Star.
Mm-hmm.
Oh yeah, yeah, the remix. 5-Star chick. No.
I got a thing for you with Keisha Cole.
Get out of here.
This little Kim
always with Monica.
Get the fuck out of here, Trina.
Kim, no.
Trina, wrong person. Go get Kaya.
Yeah, Kaya.
Kaya, like seriously, like you don't want no smoke with no fucking Kim.
Facts.
It's disrespectful.
It is.
It's very disrespectful, Trina.
To even think
you got a shot with her. Like, she's like your fucking mother, you know what I mean?
What?
You're not my dad! Okay. You also hear something! Ugly ass fucking noodle.
Nah, he said fucking.
All right, so look. So speaking of Thriller. Triller, is it Triller?
Triller.
No H.
May 29th, Tyson Holyfield.
Oh, that's happening?
It's going down.
But before that, Logan Paul, Mayweather?
I don't know what day that is. I know June 12th, I will be in Atlantic City. I got invited to the Peter Guns versus Cisco fight.
Is Cisco going to be wearing a thong?
Bruh.
Not that Cisco.
That's the Cisco I thought of.
There's another Cisco.
That's
stupid as fuck.
Rest in peace, Albie Cisco from Harlem. where the Mace dance came from. You know the Mace dance is really Albie Cisco. Mace, all the moves that Mace used to do.
Really?
Yeah, that's all. Albie Cisco used to do that at the Rucker. He died a couple years ago.
No, Cisco from Love and Hip Hop. A tall, bald-headed nigga with a goatee. Light skin. He fighting him.
He's fighting your mans?
Fighting Peter Guns. On the same ticket is This is the wildest fight of all time.
Said, not filthy.
Aaron
rich,
Carter
but bitch, I'm barely
versus
going.
Lamar Odom, son.
What the fuck is going on, son?
I'll tell you what's going on. COVID has created so many new lanes. Remember, boxing kind of went away. Everything. All the contact sports went away. So it's like, hey, celebrities are getting a ring. So now that one or two happened, it's like, shit, who else want to fight? They just created new lanes.
I think the Nate Robinson shit did this. Nate Robinson.
Oh, that's what. No, well, actually, the Conor McGregor, Floyd, actually.
Yeah, but they're boxers.
But that was still at, no, Conor's not a boxer. He's a.
He's a.
But that's that didn't make sense to nobody. We couldn't see the sense.
He's
of, like,
a fighter, though, at least.
Boy, he's an MMA fighter. It's like, why the fuck is you fighting Floyd Mayweather? Like, that was the first time it came out and it didn't make sense. Yeah, so now it's like, shit, who else?
So let's watch more shit that don't make sense.
Right. Well, I mean, look at a whole bunch of people trying to get into WWE.
Yeah.
All of this shit.
All these artists. I heard Lil Baby trying to rematch the basketball.
Oh, nah, he needs to.
Yo, yeah. Bill Baby, chill out, bro.
He needs to rebat.
That might have been the most embarrassing spectacle I've ever seen in my life. That was wild, son.
He need to rematch the studio.
He need to rematch the fucking, go to the court, nigga.
Just shoot free throws all day.
Just stay away from
all. Y'all think Lil Baby's like the muggest rapper ever?
No.
He always looked like he just woke up.
Didn't really think
about
it.
Yeah, he do like.
Puffy face. You know how you look when you first wake up? What's up? Like the mug, you know what I mean?
Nah, there's definitely uglier rappers.
He do look like he just woke up.
He mug. I will say this, though. Lil Baby's definitely the number one rapper out right now.
Facts.
Like, he is, and I think he has been.
He's
for
in
a
the
while.
Top. He's in the top.
I'm not saying he's a. Who owned 2020?
You gotta DaBaby? You got to put DaBaby. It's one, either one
DaBaby
of the babies.
DaBaby owned 2000. I'll give DaBaby 2020.
Nah, I still give it to Lil Baby.
One of the babies.
DaBaby had 2020.
I don't know, because DaBaby is too repetitive.
He had hits. Like, he had smash hits.
I know.
Like two.
I'm talking about like the most respected pen right now in rap.
Pen? Oh, nah, that's a different story.
All right, play this. I have not heard a Lil Baby song I don't like.
Me neither.
Like, he don't drop no whack shit. I heard some duds from DaBaby. Like,
yeah, me too.
I heard a couple of duds. Lil Baby don't drop no bullshit. That's what I'm saying. Anything, I'm not saying he got the best pen, but anything he puts his pen
DaBaby
and decides to put out,
Lil Baby is definitely a better rapper.
Yeah, 100%.
That's off rip.
But DaBaby can rap.
I think it's
not garbage.
I think they're about the same as far as skill level, but I think we all prefer Baby a little more.
But did we talk
Lil
about
Baby?
Did we talk about this on the last show? Like, the nigga put Drake in the spin cycle, like for
sure.
What
song was that? What song?
Oh, Wants and Needs.
Oh, the new shit.
Yeah. You still ain't hear it?
Nah, I still didn't hear it.
What? Jesus. You sleep? Bro, them three songs stay on repeat.
I'm gonna keep it 100 with you, son. Like, he didn't have to do Drake. Like
REM
that,
sleep.
He went crazy. And Drake verse was crazy. It's just like how they say Eminem killed Jay-Z, which I always felt was bullshit. I think that narrative kind of took off when Nas said it.
You don't, and this is my opinion, you don't, being an ex-writer and shit, being in the studio with niggas, you can't, if my verse is good, you didn't kill me.
Right.
Killing me is when you make me sound bad. Like, you make me sound like I shouldn't have been on the record.
Right.
I'll tell you what that happened at. That happened on...
Anything with Birdman on it?
No. It happened on all the shit that verse that everybody was like losing their mind to, that Kendrick verse.
That was
on the Big Sean shit.
Big Sean's verse was better.
It was the way how Kendrick just went at everybody head.
He had shock value.
But the thing about it is, there was another verse after that.
Yeah. But Big Sean's verse was better too.
But the thing about it is, nobody listened to that verse. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Niggas cut it off after Kendrick shit.
Yeah.
Same shit on Nigga We Made It. The remix with Jay Electronica.
Oh.
Nobody want to hear that shit. Niggas skip right past it. You go right to Hov shit.
Oh, right.
Niggas don't want to hear that fake deep shit. That Hov. I'm like, son, come on, son. Mm-hmm. Niggas want to hear Top Hop Off the Slave. Matter of fact, we could play that on him. Can we?
I wouldn't do it.
Yes, yeah, Jay-Z.
I wouldn't do it.
Hop Off the Slave Ship. Hop on my chain and took it to Jacob. I got it. Go played it. He killed that shit. Walking this bitch like, nigga, we made it. I own my own masters. He got that Drake in that song. Sorry, Mr. Drizzy, for so much y'all talk. Silly me rapping about shit that I really bought.
Yeah.
All right, anyways. I'm on my Lupita Django, stunting on stage after 8 years of slave. I figured something out about Jay-Z, 12 years of slave. I figured out something, fuck you. I figured out something about Jay-Z, too.
I whispered it.
Why he wears hair like that.
Basquiat? You want to look like Basquiat?
That's exactly why he do it. If you look at his clothes, the nigga stay with a Basquiat shirt on. Yeah. The nigga is really trying to be Basquiat. That's crazy.
That's kind of weird.
I didn't think he could get mugger.
Yo, Jesus. Son.
That's a life. No. That's a life. That's a life.
Bro.
She was so sincere.
For real, because I'm honest about it. Muggy.
We got to sit down and do that. We did it with Jari. We got to do it with you, James.
What?
We did the Muggers Rappers. We really sat down and did that. Remember, we had Slim.
It wasn't Mugg.
Like a whole, remember he's like a chorus bit. Nigga, we did. We did.
You did Mugg?
You don't remember that shit? So that shit was hilarious.
Why don't I remember that?
Bro, we took my baby. We did Lurk. We said his brother. Nigga said,
Yeah, we
called
did.
Yeah. So remember that shit?
I said he looked like dead. Yeah, that's true. That's
no, you said, ain't that nigga dead?
Yeah,
like, no, why?
Nigga said he looked dead.
Why I looked up top 10 ugliest rappers of all time, and look what they did to Lil Wayne face. That's Mr. B.
Oh, nah, Lil Wayne is. Lil Wayne might got it.
Yeah.
I'm interested in it. What's it?
Lil Wayne might got it.
All right, so Flavor Flav, for sure. 100%. That nigga look like ass.
Yeah,
Jay-Z.
The joke in the
Flavor Chris One.
Who?
Karis.
Oh, Karis One.
Lil Wayne. Yeah. Manny Fresh. Ugly.
No.
Yo, why he look like, he look like Finesse. Yo. Nah. Finesse and Jari? Had a baby?
Yo, fix that mic.
Finesse and Jari had a baby? Finesse and Jari, y'all had a baby?
Yo, hold on.
What? You not my dad! You also hear something! Ugly ass fucking.
Yo, Manny Mugg. Hold on. Coolio for sure.
Oh, yeah.
And they used the old picture.
The old picture.
They could have put the young Coolio.
Bismarcky.
Ooh.
Because his teeth, his grill is trash.
Ooh.
Benzino.
The neck.
Nah.
It's the neck.
This wig is way mugger than Benzino.
Lil Jon.
Nah. I don't like that.
Young Thug.
Nah, not even Thug.
Young Thug is number one.
When Young Thug first came out?
Yeah.
He had the motherfucking shark teeth, nigga.
Who else they got on there?
That was 10.
They missed mad niggas, son.
They missed Craig Mack.
Craig Crunchy Black,
six,
son.
6ix9ine is on another one.
I'm not mad at that. Yeah.
Why they put Gucci on the Lil Pump?
Yeah. No, not no more.
They put Nicki Minaj.
Oh.
Post Malone. Chief Keef.
Post Malone just look like he on drugs.
Yeah, Chief Keef.
Started off the door with a ball.
Trinidad James.
Walking us a fall. This is a wall. A wall.
Old Dirty Bastard. Whoa.
You know what he sound like? He sound like he just got his tooth pulled out.
Old Dirty Bastard.
Old Dirty Bastard.
Nah, come on,
rest in peace. Rest in peace.
Come on, son. Nah, that nigga,
Busta Rhymes. Yo.
That's come on, son. Busta not that
they
mug.
Got Busta.
He's not that. Come on, Busta bro. Not that mug, son.
Nah, he's not, but why come they on. Got him on here?
Busta was like a borderline sex symbol. Like for two years.
Trippy Red is ugly as fuck.
He's just yellow.
He's just light skinned with no facial hair.
And red, orange.
Yeah, he's weird.
He looks weird.
He's weird.
He's a weird looking nigga. For sure.
I can see the Magoosity.
All right, let's get off of that. Right? We'll stay on that shit forever. Let's get into now, right? Y'all told me to put the somber shit in the middle.
Please.
Rest in peace to the Colorado victims. Mm. I don't know too much about that story, but I do know they caught the gunman. Of course.
Like a mass shooting.
Of course, they let him out in cuffs and, you know, gave him some cocoa.
What's this, the Asian massacre joint?
No, this happened in Colorado.
What are we talking about?
Actually, I got some updates on that. And fuck you, Kwesi, beforehand. All right, it might feed into your shit a little bit. But here's a conspiracy theory.
Oh. Fridge is open.
I'm going to play something that Biden said. And it made me think about Kwesi immediately. All right, so y'all do know about the mass shooting that took place in Colorado. A dude killed 10 people.
Mm-hmm. No.
Really?
That's all I knew.
Yeah, it wasn't a black man being killed by the police. So, of course, it's not going to get that much news.
Right,
you know what
right,
I'm saying?
Right, right, right. Got you.
Because one black man being killed by police is way more important than 10 people getting killed. You know what I mean? You know.
Right.
I hate y'all.
Right, you would think that would get heavy. Really, I mean, it got news play, but real silent because it was 10 people. Excuse me. But Biden spoke about it. And all right, let me read about the Colorado shooting. All right, so was it a store? All right, the terrifying hours as employees and shoppers hid when a gunman went into a shopping spree at a Colorado grocery store. A gunman wearing an armored or tactical vest had just shot an elderly man outside of the King Supers on Monday afternoon in Boulder, Colorado. Inside a supermarket, staff watched in disbelief as the gunman stood over the man and fired again and again. After the gunman entered the store, there were three more gunshots. Employees, some shoppers fled and hid, some in the back, some upstairs to a room, some in the outside the pharmacy as the suspect roamed aisles, according to witnesses and an affidavit for an arrest warrant. When the shopper Ryan Borowski realized there were gunshots, it took a terrified woman running toward him for him to realize he should scatter too. I turned up and kept up with her. And we all ran down the aisle toward the back of the store together, where they huddled with employees. I saw a lot of very wide eyes. I'm sure my eyes were just as terrified as everybody else's. It's quotation, so I'm gonna.
Okay.
I'm imagining that's
how he talks.
That definitely was his energy.
No, we appreciate it.
Calls pulled to 911 dispatches the first around 2:30 p.m. At the end of the day, definitely, and what had been regular day of errand chores in this university town beside the Rocky Mountains, northwest of Denver, was shattered forever. While some shoppers and employees managed to hide, 10 people were shot dead by a lone assailant. Monday's victims were Boulder Police Chief Officer Eric Talley, 51, Store Manager Ricky Olds, 25, Store Employee Denny Strong, 20, Store Employee Terry Leaker, 51, Nevin Stanisic, 23, Trelona Bartowiak, 49,
Whoa.
Suzanne Fountain, 59, Kevin Mahoney, 61, Lynn Murray, 62, and Jody Waters, 65.
All these names sound fake, but...
Everybody rest in peace. And here's the thing. A suspect, Ahmed Al-Awi Alisa, 21, was taken into custody after a gunfire exchange was responding.
Oh, that's what we doing once we heard Ahmed?
Now, all right. Yeah, yeah. That's back.
Terrorism?
That's back. You see me as terrorism. See a big homie dead and you can get buried with him. Step bro and I know he hit him. Bow, 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 bow. All right.
That face was crazy. Your eyes were spaced the fuck out.
Bow, 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 bow.
Yo.
We can't, Nick. I just read off 10 dead people. Y'all here making jokes.
He's making the sound effects. Bow, 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 bow.
So what's the Biden part? What's the
okay?
Fuck going on?
Yeah, this is a little
My premenopause is kicking in.
Yo,
thank you.
Premenopause.
Premeno.
For a 27-year-old.
Thank you. All right,
this was a little troubling to me. How quickly he said this. Let me pull this up. I was like, we're going to have to talk about this on the show. Where is it? Me and Black going black in the late night. You're going to know who did it when the face white.
Cry Bill Biden.
Game goes skin through. Put a dot on his head like he Hindu. Get cooked like a dinner plate. Do a drill and we back on the interstate. Put a bow. Do a drill with my guys and we sit and wait.
Look.
Look.
Let me talk to him.
Look.
Look.
Are y'all ready? This is our President Biden talking about the Boulder, Colorado situation.
You're going to ask me to speculate. Understandably, you'd ask me to speculate about what happened, why it happened. And I'm not going to do that now because we don't have all the information. Not until I have all the facts. But I do know this. As president, I'm going to use all the resources at my disposal to keep the American people safe. As I said, at this moment, a great deal remains unknown. I don't need to wait another minute, let alone an hour, to take common sense steps that will save the lives in the future and to urge my colleagues in the House and Senate to act.
Here we go.
We can ban assault weapons and high-capacity magazines.
I agree with that. I've always agreed with that. We don't need assault weapons. No man on earth needs an assault weapon.
Right.
An assault rifle.
In this country, once again. I got that done when I was a senator. It passed. It was law for the longest time. and it brought down these mass killings.
Yeah.
We should do it again.
Yeah, I agree.
We can close the loopholes in our background check system, mm-hmm. including the Charleston loophole. Mm-hmm. That's one of the best tools we have right now to prevent gun violence. The Senate should immediately pass. Let me say it again. The United States Senate, I hope some are listening, should immediately pass the two House-passed bills that close loopholes in the background check system. These are bills that receive votes of both Republicans and Democrats in the House. This is not and should not be a partisan issue. This is an American issue.
What does that mean when they say partisan?
It will save lives, American lives.
Partisan means, I don't want to give you the wrong definition of it. It means like an issue where people can debate on. It should be same across the board.
So it just means debatable. It means it should be,
right, it's not something that people should, debate. It's like, this is like, should be something everybody agree on.
Got it, thanks.
I agree with Biden on that. But my conspiracy theory comes in where, when I say.
What was that sound?
I don't know.
Some device did something, but yeah.
I just want to make sure nothing died.
No, that was my phone disconnected from the camera.
Okay.
What does that mean?
No, my phone just disconnected from it. If it stopped recording, it would have told me. Oh, I think it did, actually. Hold on, let me pause real quick. All right, sorry about that, ladies and gentlemen. We had to take a quick break. Technical difficulties, you know what I mean? We still getting our shit together. You know what I mean? Okay, I don't like that sound. Here's my question to you guys. What do we think about my arch nemesis? I have two arch nemesises. One of them.
Nemesises was
nice. I have two.
It's a lot of syllables.
One is Hassan Campbell. I can't stand that motherfucker. I can't stand that frog face motherfucker, bro. Like, son. You know he got a very smackable face. Like, I can't stand that nigga, son.
You know you can't. He can't stand him. He pronounced motherfucker with the ER.
I can't stand that motherfucker.
Motherfucker.
I can't stand a nigga.
You gotta be real mad.
And I got one more nigga who I can't stand. And I'm so glad about the news we received about this fuck nigga over the weekend. You know what I mean? Over the last couple of days. You know what I'm saying? I'm gonna tell that nigga one thing. You know what I'm saying?
Oh, like,
I got one thing to say to this nigga. You know what I'm saying? Where the fuck is my shit at? Oh, fuck, man.
Oh.
Oh, fuck that, man.
I'm proud of you with my brother on the phone. When I beat you on Paru, you going to bed, nigga.
You going to bed, Derrick Jackson.
Line it up with blood.
Yeah. I can't stand that simp-ass nigga.
Who, Derrick Simpson?
Derrick Simpson. Derrick Simpson. A.K.A. Derrick. And I hate the way he spells his name. J-A-X-N.
Max.
I like it, though.
What? How you hate the way he spells his name?
Because it's narcissistic. To fancy up your own name.
He's like a Kanye.
Worse.
Yeah, very weird.
Kanye doesn't manipulate anybody.
Yeah.
Kanye only cares about it. I don't think Kanye is... He's narcissistic, but it's harmless.
I don't think he's manipulating. Mm.
Kanye is narcissistic, but it's narcissism.
Non-malicious.
Yes, it's harmless. It's malicious, but it's harmless. Because it doesn't affect anybody but himself.
Yeah,
like he's the only one that suffers as a result of his narcissism.
I guess.
But Derrick Jackson has been poisoning the mind of women with his bullshit and his manipulation for years. Just bashing men after men after men. You know what I'm saying? He even got at your boy. Y'all want to hear some of what he tried to do to me?
Let's hear it.
Let's hear it. Let's hear what he tried to do to me. What old Jackson did to me.
Jackson Simpson.
This is what he did to me a couple. He went at Gilly. Gilly got him back. This is what he said about me. All right. If y'all remember, this is a video I had.
This term being thrown around too loose.
This is a video I had years ago. This was in 2018. Mm-hmm. And I had a lot of women on board. And I had some mad, but we know who were mad. And Derrick Jackson felt the need. This is when I found out who the nigga was. I didn't even know who this bitch-ass nigga was before that.
Uppercase B on that.
What?
This is what he did to me.
This term being thrown around too loosely, and I'm quite sick of hearing it, man. Tired of all of these chicks calling themselves queens, and they don't even love themselves. I'm an 80s baby, man. All my crushes growing up were real women. natural beauties, real titties, real ass, real face. Everything about them was gorgeous. Even their attitudes, everything, man.
Gorgeous.
Nowadays, all these chicks want to call themselves queens. Self-proclaimed. Ain't earned no title. And y'all call them queens, too. Mm-hmm. Y'all respect that shit? It's nice to look at. Nice to have sex with.
I remember this
but
video.
But to wife that up? Hell no, I'm good. All of these bozo-ass niggas be wifing these chicks up because they wasn't getting no chicks when they was growing up. They don't even know what the standard of a beautiful woman is. Nowadays, the standard is being fake. Being fake is the new real, and y'all respect that? Y'all call them queens? They ain't no fucking queens. They don't even love themselves. Bring the natural women back, the real women.
All right. Like, yeah. You had a problem with that?
No.
That's me bigging up natural women.
Yeah.
Which is the majority.
Right.
And here's what Jerick Jackson had to say about that video.
At first, I kind of felt where he was coming from. I did. Because I'd be the first to tell you, I love natural women too. I think natural is beautiful, you know?
We saw your wife, nigga. She is as natural as they come. Was that wrong?
Yeah. Nah, was there not a...
Naturally,
calm down.
Calm down.
I constantly praise those women that's working with what God gave them, especially in a world that tries to make women fit into a specific mold and don't look like what a lot of women got blessed with naturally. I'm all for that, but...
He should have left it right there. Watch the narrative Nazi nigga right here, bro. Watch what he did to my video, son.
He lost me at a couple of detours and ended up in the city of bullshit. When he started making his personal, romantic, or sexual, or wifeable preference... the measurement of a woman in whole, as real or fake, or as a queen or not a queen. Because we don't do that shit for men. We don't do that shit for men. For these dudes out here that have replaced all their teeth with gold fronts, we don't say they ain't no king. All these dudes.
You see what he did, son? You see what he did?
Like,
you see what this bitch ass nigga did, son?
How you completely
use a video with the intentions of bigging up the naturality of women. And started shitting on men? How did you do that, my nigga?
And his segue was trash because he tried to equate a gold front, a gold grill,
bro,
to a fake ass.
That's trash.
That's not the same. That's a bad analogy,
that's
bro.
That's not a modification.
This is
to
what
your
he
body.
Does. Let me finish.
Exactly.
The nigga literally, that's what he does. My video went viral and he took the opportunity to shit on men.
Yeah.
And if my video was to praise natural beauty.
Yeah.
And it's also because he knew women would probably watch that and feel some type of way. Yeah, but only, so now he's going to go off on niggas.
Right, but,
you know?
Right. That's exactly what he
That's
did.
Always his move, though.
So if we tatted up hairlines now, we don't say, oh, you don't love yourself because you ain't got the hairline that God blessed you with.
We don't say we do.
No,
yeah, we do.
And I'm not saying you can't have your romantic preference, whatever. Women like tall dudes, short dudes, buff dudes, dudes with beards. Men are allowed to as well. But that ain't no measurement of a king or queen. But I do agree with him on one part. When he said that the term queen is used a little loosely these days, I agree with him on that. Although the way that he's using it, it ain't just loose. It done fell the fuck apart. But a king or a queen is somebody who's a role model based on their character. Based on their character, not on how they look. Somebody that, if there was more people like that person, the world would be a...
You see what I'm saying? That's not what I was saying. What I was saying is women are proclaiming themselves queens based off the way they look.
But that's exactly what he's saying is exactly what you said.
That's exactly what I said, you fucking idiot. That's exactly what I said.
Yeah. Yeah, that's annoying.
That was wild.
He tried to change my narrative giving me my narrative, bro. Like,
yeah, changing the nigga narrative is crazy. So.
By taking his narrative is wild.
Not a better place to find somebody to fuck, not a better place to find somebody to wife, a better place to live in. But sidebar, if we're going to have this conversation about a woman that we want a wife versus a woman that we just want to
watch love, this.
Let's have it, honestly. Let's keep it G. Truth is, most of these dudes out here ain't trying to wife nobody. And it's...
Son, all the way shitting on men, son.
And that's all the way cap.
Why is that necessary, though, to do the tear part my beautiful presentation? Why was that necessary, bro?
Yeah.
How can you elaborate on a great point? Just elaborate further on what I said.
Yeah.
How you gonna take it and change the narrative, bro? This nigga is a fuck nigga for real, bro. Yeah, son, when he
natural girls,
this video got. Remember Cashflow Harlem?
Yeah.
Remember he took this video and did the rap, and I attacked him. Then I had to apologize because he didn't do that.
He attacked him. He was like, "Yo, that shit was good. Yeah, thanks. For, you know, I like what you did with my shit."
No, I said that's fucked up that you took my shit and didn't give me no credit. Oh. And then he came back.
Damn, I don't remember.
I went at the nigga. And then he came back and said, yo, thank you for the inspiration, big bro. And I didn't see it. So I made a whole video about him stealing my shit.
Yeah.
But he had already given me my credit and I didn't see it. Because he didn't, he saw my video and he took it and did something different with it.
I didn't know that.
And also, the nigga Derrick Jackson put like share over my name so people couldn't know who made the original video. Because I'm pretty sure most of the overweight fucking women, like his wife, no, his wife is not overweight.
Definitely.
Most of the women I was talking about look like his fucking wife.
As far as?
As far as natural beauties. His wife is natural as they come.
Right. Yep.
So I'm talking about your fucking wife, nigga. Meanwhile, you're dissing, you're contradicting. I'm fucking old. I'm there.
He can't imagine.
Why? Because we too busy still trying to fuck with the girls that we say ain't wifeable. Or we will wife that wifey type. We will wife that natural girl. And we'll break a heart, or we'll lose her because we trying to fuck on the girls that we say ain't wifeable.
Stop that real quick. Uh-oh.
Hold on. Wait.
Wow.
Whoa. Wait a minute. I didn't even know that my own video
made him come clean.
It's fuel.
Yeah.
You know what I need to do?
He came clean in there.
He did.
He came clean in my video.
He was talking about himself.
Bro.
Yeah,
wait. Run it back. You can hear it in his tone.
Wait a minute.
You can hear it, right?
Back for the people.
You mean to
back.
Tell me in the
crazy,
video?
Yeah, your rebehavior and tone.
Yeah, do I nuts. Need to do? Hold on. We gonna break this down. Do I need to do a commentary on my video
like he did.
Of him doing a commentary on my video
about him? Yes. Oh, viral.
Yo, viral
movie.
Bow.
Bow. It's happening.
And no, it happened.
Run it back.
It happened.
Yo, son.
Run it back.
Wow, I had to. Oh, wait.
That's your funny, bro.
Yo, you peeking, bro.
Hold on. The whole time I'm making videos about him, I had the arsenal the whole time.
Yeah.
I have it. I'm the owner of it.
Yeah, his reaction to you.
Wow, his reaction to me is the reaction of himself.
Run the blood.
That's
run
crazy.
Run the rhythm.
Rhythm to blood seed, bro.
Oh, my God.
Yo.
He is a reflection of his own insecurities.
We'll wipe that natural girl, and we'll break a heart.
Run it back a little earlier.
Go back.
He was talking about himself.
We will wipe that wifey type. We will wipe that natural girl. And then, there's plenty of natural girls walking around.
Then what you
Why?
Do?
Why? Because we too busy still trying to fuck on the girls that we say ain't wifeable.
Run it back.
We will wipe that wifey type. We will wipe that natural girl. And we'll break a heart.
Soundbite.
Or we'll lose her because we trying to fuck on the girls that we say ain't
wifeable. Whoa, Derek, what? What you did, Derek?
Soundbite.
Yo, Derek, what you did with your natural girl? Run it back. What you did with your natural girl?
You told us already.
What you did with her?
And people just...
What you did, Derek?
And I'm going to pop her picture on the video.
And he's saying we all over this shit.
Derek, what you did?
And we'll break a heart.
Damn.
Or we'll lose her because we're trying to fuck on the girls that we say ain't wifeable.
Damn, Derek.
So how valuable is the wifey type, really?
How valuable
Beyond the Instagram memes and videos and repost and share. Like, that shit is cool. The captions is cool. But our actions said we don't really give a fuck about the wifey type. We giving all our attention to the rest of the girls.
Oh.
And we really going to keep it G and have this conversation.
Keep it G. He said
but
we.
Back to what I was saying,
he
man.
Said we, though.
Whether or not a woman is a queen ain't got shit to do with her physical. And I'm not one of those people that say every woman is a queen. I don't believe that.
But that's not what
every
you were saying.
Every man ain't no king. Every woman ain't no queen. If we strictly speaking to the topic of women, these deadbeat and toxic moms is ruining these kids, that ain't no queen. Scammer chicks, that ain't no queen. These girls that's trying to fuck on their girl's man or husband, that ain't no queen. A girl that's in a relationship with a dude, hardworking, he a good guy, but she secretly want her ex, so she constantly belittling her man because she never got over her ex guy, that ain't no queen.
That's on that personal.
But it ain't got nothing to do with where she get her ass and titties from.
This nigga's literally the corny thing of my life. Guess
and real kings know this.
What are you, or guess you told me, suck my dick, nigga.
That's crazy.
Suck my dick. This is what I'm saying, like, this is how you. This,
I guess you told me.
Yeah, this is how you know niggas is cornballs. Real niggas knew exactly what I was talking about. Yeah. That's how I met Lil Mama.
Yeah.
From that video.
Yeah, I remember.
She loved it. She was like, "Wow, that's what I'm talking about."
And she's natural.
Yeah.
The whole point of it was, you got all of these, and I'm going to say it again in 2021, like I said in 2018. You got chicks who have a low self-esteem, mm-hmm. who look like shit mm-hmm. or look regular. I ain't going to say shit. They look very regular. They go out and get their bodies done, and now all of a sudden, I'm a queen.
Yeah.
That was the point of the video. So natural women do not feel slighted about who they are.
Right.
Right.
I was praising natural women and who are confident within themselves. Yeah. You know what I'm saying?
Very clear.
Very clear. And this fuck nigga went ahead and changed the narrative. Now look at you, nigga. Laughing stock of the internet, of the world. Fucking hypocritical bitch. I'm glad that that happened to you, nigga. I hope you get canceled. Hope your book, nigga, book 50% off now. Why? Nigga, it's quiet for that book, nigga.
Nigga, use them, bitch.
That would hit.
Nigga, use them, bitch.
One more time. Fuck that nigga, man.
Nigga, use them, bitch. Nigga, use them, bitch.
And I'm telling you with my brother on the phone, when I beat you on Power Room, you going to bed, nigga.
Yo, chicks, line,
yo,
up.
Nigga, line up that celebrity.
Yo, line, yo, line
yo,
it up with blood.
I am. Line up that celebrity.
We know. I want
to
fight that nigga, son. On, nigga. On.
All, well, all his chicks are in Orlando, nigga, so nigga. I'm pretty sure he's familiar with the area.
That's a life.
I swear to God, I'll beat the shit out that nigga, son.
Yo.
All
right. I know. We know you would.
Yeah.
He corny.
Cornball ass fuck nigga. Son, I hate that nigga, son.
He be in Orlando.
He come out here and pull up on him. Whatever seminar he at, nigga.
Size shorty just from Orlando, so.
Let me tell you something, Derek Jackson. You know what I'm saying? Let me tell you something, bro.
He be out here.
All that big shit don't mean nothing, nigga.
I know where he be.
Let me tell you something, bro.
Yo, we know where
this he is. This is the difference. I'm a former, I'm going to say knucklehead. That's like an old nigga. I'm a former nigga. I got niggas that'll run down.
Back in my day. Old right, ass nigga.
Right. You in Atlanta, I get niggas to run down on you, boy. Don't play with me, nigga.
Stop.
Don't play with me, nigga. You know what I mean?
I'm tired of being humble, and I'm tired of being low-key. Now I'm about to pull my motherfucking whips out. I'm about to show y'all what my crib looks like, and I'm about to roll with my niggas and smack niggas up that's talking.
Ray J!
And after I fuck you up, watch, nigga. You.
I broke my back.
You, nigga. You.
What do you mean by that? You broke
my back is broken.
What do you mean by
spinal.
That?
A vertebrae or a portion?
Spinal.
And the crowd after that, nigga. You know what I mean? After I fuck you up, Derek Jackson.
And then his girlfriend be like, calm down. Oh, his wife, sorry, Sam.
Derek Jackson, respectfully.
Nigga, use them, bitch.
Y'all got anything to say about this nigga, man? Did I say enough?
I think you got it.
About him, enough. Can we move on to his wife?
Poor girl.
What's up, chicks?
You know,
what's up?
Go ahead, chicks.
So when I first seen the videos, I'm like, all right, she's natural. I respected the fact that she came out there raw, but I'm like, damn, that raw? Like, come on, sis. Like, right. Make your
that
man.
That was skinless.
You support your man. You got to make your man. You know. So then I go onto her page.
So the bitch with the she had the gi on. You know the gi is right.
Nah.
Yo,
the karate suit.
She
in the fighting pose with the cat.
It was black.
No, it was white. But she was like, and the bitch can't fight. She was like a yellow belt.
Stop it. She might fuck you up, Dirt. She plot twist.
Yellow belt.
That bitch is smoothie beat that bitch up.
Which is yellow.
Stop. Man, fuck it, man.
So she was like, I was kind of upset watching her. Like it made me. I was belittled. Yeah. Because how you going to stand there and he going to have the hardest motherfucking grip on your hand. And right. You just sitting there. Like you.
Here's the thing about that, Jinx.
She right. Looked really
people keep talking about she's
manipulated.
A mess. He's a mess. He just came up in his field.
Yeah.
She just stayed exactly where she was at. True. He married that.
So
I saw the
corny.
Pictures. We got to throw them out. I saw the pictures of them when they was in high school.
Yeah, I saw
that. I saw the pictures. That nigga was a flabby, fat nigga with no mustache. Corny, he was bent. I need to find a video I made about that nigga in 2018 when I went off on him. I went off on him about that video, him critiquing my video. Mm. And I said about him, that, I nigga, Quincy, Chinks, we grew up a little different. Like, we're niggas love you, chicks love us, respectfully. Mm-hmm. We're well-versed in the opposite sex. You can tell from a person's speech if they corny. Mm-hmm. Like Fab said, you cannot uncorny yourself. Once you corny forever. I knew that nigga was corny. First of all, to do what he do, he's corny. That's why he married.
T-shirts got it.
Respectfully, that's why he married that corny ass chick.
T-shirts is crazy.
One girl say, "Yo, you gonna come on camera?"
They're back. I'm sorry, but you the pictures.
The t-shirts. That was 2019. I've been trying to kill that nigga. That was a year after he got
out. What year did he just say?
Yeah, it was
2018 is when the beef started. 2019 is when I was still going at him. Yeah. Every time I do a video and I talk about a bitch nigga, his picture. How many times? Yeah, I mean him. That nigga constantly, bro.
Yeah, he was the default.
Default bitch nigga.
That's funny.
Derrick Jackson, we don't even got to fight, my nigga. Come on my show, bro. Talk to me, bro.
And Shorty.
Talk to me, my nigga.
She got them karate.
Like, talk for real. Like, this is what I'm saying. Like, I need to know you organically. Listen, first of all, I don't even put nobody on blast. But I know your mistress, bro. Yeah. I saw your messages. I heard what you were saying. You a cornball nigga. What kind of panties you got on?
No.
What kind of shit is that? Yo, you ever asked a girl what color her panties is, nigga?
No.
What are you, a construction worker, my nigga? a 58-year-old construction worker? You some diesel nigga who desirable in the eyes of women, and your attitude is that of a fucking creep. You creepy-ass cornball-ass nigga.
That's mad creepy.
Cornball-ass nigga. You know what I mean?
What are you going to confirm?
What he did, he been a cornball, and I can tell when he's sitting in that truck, when I call with the V-neck shirt on. The nigga got on flare jeans. He a flare jean.
Yeah, he give me flare jeans.
Not he give me flare jean. Vibe. What's the boot called? What the boot? What's the
boot? A boot cut.
No. The boots that niggas wear.
Which boots?
But he wearing whatever. I got a pair. But
oh, the
what's the boots called? Everybody wear.
The nice looking ones.
Yes.
Right?
He that nigga. No, he wear Durangos. That nigga still wear Durangos. He definitely a blazer jean type nigga. Big blazer with the big jeans.
fat
V-neck shirt
jeans.
Tucked in. Fat jeans.
Not tucked in.
Probably with a motorcycle chain on.
With the fat blazer.
The pocket that links to the chain. Cornball ass nigga. Yeah.
Cornball ass fuck nigga. Always by himself. No friends. No family. And we see why you ain't got your wife on camera.
Always in the car too.
Always in the car. Team Jack batting his eyes like a bitch. Fuck you, nigga.
Oh, that's funny.
I beat that big nigga up. No cap.
Yeah.
Fuck that.
Shots fired. You've been called out.
Anyway, enough about that nigga, man. Enough about that fuck ass nigga, cuz. Speaking of fuck niggas, NBA Youngboy. Nah, this is fucked up. NBA Youngboy is a nigga in jail. Matter of fact, before the computer died, let's get to this Chinks. And I got to apologize that we never talked about this before. We'll get back to the NBA Youngboy, but before the computer died, could be running out. How do you feel about the violence that's taking place towards Asians?
I knew you was going to ask me.
No, seriously, and I'm surprised we haven't talked about it. Like, do you feel any way about that?
I don't, but I feel like, that was kind of...
She said, I don't know them niggas.
Not even, but it's because it wasn't really, like, brought to my attention.
You ain't my son.
Now, like, I've heard about it, but I didn't think it was really happening, and apparently it has been happening for a while.
All right. What was this? I'll say. I believe that what they're highlighting is just one area in the country, right?
Yeah. Our home, you know, Ika, her family's salon was right next to the massage parlor where it happened.
But it's happened a lot.
Yeah.
It's happened a lot.
I know.
But when I pull this video up, speaks on, racism.
It's really sad, just to answer your question, because it's not like I don't feel for it. I just, there's not much I could say. If it happened to a family member, I would be irate, of course.
You don't give a fuck unless they hit home.
Not that I don't give a fuck, but I do feel bad. Like, I feel like that shit's fucked up, obviously. it's stupid. But I feel like, you know, there's hate crime toward all types of races. So
I'm going to play this video because I heard it already, but I want you guys to hear what she had to say, and I'm going to elaborate on it. Because she was all over the place with this shit.
I'm done with you Asians who think having a race war with the black community is in our favor. No, it fucking is not. And y'all always want to bring up black people attacking Asians during the post-COVID era, which has happened a few times, but guess what, bitch? There are going to be bad people in every race. Remember, anti-Asianness is always rooted in white supremacy, but a person of any race can be influenced by white supremacy. So those black people that attacked us were subscribing to the white supremacist narrative that Asians caused COVID.
I appreciate you doing that, Asian girl, but no. No, they're not. They're just pieces of shit.
Keep going. If you blame black people as a whole for the anti-Asian hate crimes, you're subscribing to the white supremacist narrative that black people...
Okay. You're subscribing to the white supremacist narrative by saying black people subscribe to the white supremacist narrative. She's subscribing to it by thinking that we subscribe to it.
She's stupid.
Right? You hear what I'm saying, sir? I'm going to let her finish, though.
Yeah.
Because this whole thing bothers me.
And y'all Asians who are like, why aren't black people standing with us? Bitch, be grateful because they've always stood with us. Frederick Douglass in 1882 made the time to openly denounce the Chinese Exclusion Act while the black community was going through so much, such as rampant lynchings against them. They worked hand in hand with us to free the Japanese people in the internment camps in 1942. And we directly benefited from black-led civil rights movements every single time. So stop blaming and demanding things from them and unlearn your anti-blackness first.
Okay, she said an earful. Okay. First, let me touch on this. Thank you for that. Now, I will say this. Within the Asian community, a lot of them do subscribe to the white supremacist narrative that they're better than us because we're black. Like, if you go to... But I don't see them treating white people the same. But
yeah.
The reason I say that is because a lot of things that take place in this country, when you come from another place... You get the picture of what America is from media or from what you hear from word of mouth. You don't live there, so you don't know what's going on. Mm-hmm. And, of course, they know about slavery. And then the narrative has been changed that black people are now violent.
Correct.
Right? So when they come here, it's not just Asian people. It's even black people, Jamaicans, West Indians, Africans. It's always this thing that black Americans... ain't shit. We're the lowest of the low.
Black Americans think that too.
Right, right. We think that of ourselves. Yeah. Okay. But that's definitely what's pushed on everybody in the world about black people here in America.
Okay.
So I understand why, I don't agree with it, but I understand why Asians feel that way about black people. You go to Asian neighbors, they act funny with you. And white people come over there and treat them like fucking kings. We walk in a fucking store, they look at us, they follow us around the store. White people walk in there, they don't do shit to them. Right?
I agree.
So that happens a lot, right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Now, I get what she's saying on that, but there is, it should be some concern drawn, because even me growing up, when we saw, this is real shit, my niggas in the hood, if you saw an Asian on a train or something, he was fooled. He was fooled. It was just like, rob the Chinese. It was always that. I don't even know if they were Chinese. They could have been Cambodian.
Asian.
He got slanted eyes. He Asian. He getting robbed. Niggas robbed it. That's how it was.
Yeah.
So it wasn't because he was Asian. It was because Asians are also viewed low by white people.
Very true.
So, like, everybody was always scared to touch the white people. Mm-hmm. But the Asian dude was getting robbed. He was an outsider. Like, not the Spanish dude, not the white dude. The Asian dude was getting robbed first.
Yeah.
And it was, like, an easy target. Because Asians also don't fuck with the police.
Mm-hmm.
Asians don't dial 911. Asians are a tight-knit community who police themselves.
Yeah.
Would you agree with that?
I'll say this. So, like, my family, right? My Chinese family, they live in Panama right now.
Right.
They migrated, you know, during the whole communism thing.
Right.
So they're there, and they're trying to...
And by the way, I'm sorry. By the way, there's a lot of Chinese people in Panama.
There's a lot of Chinese people everywhere, right, but yeah, especially
a lot.
In Panama.
It's a lot. Huge culture.
So when they first got there, it was kind of like they were racist toward Asians, you know, like they didn't know anything. They didn't know the language.
The Panamanians were.
Yes, Panamanians. Right. And you know, Panamanians also have black people.
Right.
So my father, he's darker, not really considered black, but in Panama, he's black.
Right.
So my grandma, my grandparents from my mother's side, they didn't really want, you know, they're traditional and shit. Mm-hmm. They didn't really want her with him. And my mom felt like that was racism, whatever. They got together, cool. Then after that, there was another incident where my grandfather owns like businesses, and a lot of the like black hood niggas from where they lived knew that. So what they did was they set him up. They sent some nigga to work for him, got close to him. Boom, they set him up. I'm talking about they pistol whipped my aunt. Like they wrapped up the kids in rope and tied them up and like it was bad. And so they thought they were going to get killed. So ever since then, it's kind of like, you know, people leave a bad taste in your mouth based off certain experiences. And it's easier for them to believe those narratives. You get what I'm saying?
Oh, but see, with them, they're doing it based off of experience.
Exactly.
That's a little more understandable.
Mm-hmm.
It's not right, but it's definitely understandable.
But it happens often to Asians, though.
Right, right.
And the story you told is common.
And it happens at the hands of black people.
True.
It's not because black people don't like Asians.
They're just a target.
Well, one.
I feel like.
Well, one, it's like this thing where you're fighting the wrong person.
Yeah.
Right? Because Asians have this thought process of black people. You know, you walk in a grocery store, or you walk in a neighborhood, they look at you funny and shit. It's always that. And then black people, we have this ultra hyper aggressive, you know, especially when you broke and you poor and you from the hood and you got to rob somebody.
Yeah.
Asians tend to be the most vulnerable.
Mm-hmm.
So I don't think it's a direct hate.
They be whooping ass though. They be coming out.
I really don't think it's a direct hate. I don't think it's about them being Asians. I think it would happen to any group.
How much is this shit happening? Will be vulnerable. First of all, like.
Well, but I also, like I said, I think the focal area is over there in California, like in, I think most of it happens like San Francisco, like Northern California area. I think that's the area where people saying stop Asian hate. It's bigger than that because it's not hate towards Asians.
Yeah, it's not.
It's people robbing the most vulnerable people.
But they poor happen people, to be Asians?
Right. Poor people robbing and beating up. And it's just like the Black Lives Matter movement. It's the same thing. Because would this be getting attention if somebody didn't catch it on tape? Because the shit obviously been happening. I gave you, this is back when I'm 40 years old. This shit happened in high school. Like, you know, in New York, you got the technical colleges. Brooklyn Tech and Bronx Science. You already knew the Asians was fooled, bro. Like, by the niggas who was robbing people.
Just the type of people that they are. They're just mad, like, and they're not as expressive as Americans because they're from another country.
Right.
So and they're easily intimidated.
But here's the thing. It could be black people buying into the white supremacy thing because black people who do rob and do commit crimes on a consistent basis, there is a fear of going to jail. You don't want to go to jail. So you do crimes you think you're able to get away with.
Mm-hmm.
Robbing an Asian person is something that black people think, I can rob this motherfucker and get away with.
Yeah.
That's a fact.
He ain't calling no cops.
Calling the cops. And if he do, and like Asians ain't going to call the police. Like, Asians don't fuck with the cops either.
Fact.
They don't
trust them.
They don't trust white people just as much as we don't.
I feel that.
So it's like you're fighting the wrong, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
In a perfect world, we all should be against the most powerful people.
Mm-hmm.
But Asians come here and try to make it. Black people have been fighting for rights and trying to make it since we've been here. So it's almost this thing where you're fighting the same enemy, but fighting against you.
So that's the connection to white supremacy, basically. It's like
it is
to get two non-whites to go against each other.
Right.
It's productive.
I think it's being called white, but like I said, it's not. Yeah, I guess it is buying into the narrative of white supremacy. But it's an involuntary, indirect thought.
I think we said it on the show recently. You can be black, white supremacist.
Right. You can be a white supremacist. You can be a black white supremacist.
For sure.
Yeah. All you got to do is believe white people superior to you.
Yeah, that's it.
And subscribe to the narrative.
That's it.
And Asians also
have to be white.
So what she said, there's some validity to it. However, the part I don't, and I like the fact that she said that, but let's not skip over the fact that it is an issue with, and particularly elderly Asians are being beaten and robbed by black people.
Can I ask why you
think?
I don't know
the numbers. I don't know if it's a real issue.
If it's happening more in places like that, like California, San Francisco, why do you think that is? Do you think it's because those areas are more populated with white people?
Here's the thing.
More Asians.
I think the Asians are more close proximity to black people.
But I feel like...
I don't think black people are going over there to travel to beat them up. I think... Put it like this. Just like black-on-black crime is a myth. Black-on-black crime is a myth because it's not black-on-black crime. It's a proximity crime. It's like, hey, I want to rob somebody.
Oh.
Who's the... you're there. Like,
yeah, it's not really premeditated. Black people in their targeting somebody.
Black people in their neighborhoods are broke. Asians tend to have their shit together.
Gotcha.
They own stuff. They have money. Fuck that. We going down a block. We know this Asian dude's already got some money.
Gotcha.
It's not about Asian people. It's about opportunity.
Yeah. I got you.
And these people aren't policed. They aren't calling the police.
Yep.
And they're vulnerable. And a lot of the older ones don't speak English.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
It's an easy lick.
Yes.
That's what it's all about. If there was a black neighborhood next door who cops also didn't give a fuck about them,
mm-hmm.
This is why you see people on social media saying, stop Asian crime.
Yeah.
Because if there was the white people, no groups of white people ever had to do that.
Yeah.
Because they're automatically policed.
Yeah.
Asian people feel like they're not protected in this country. So they have some of the same issues that black people have in this country.
Mm-hmm. Very much so.
I think it's another proximity thing. I would think, I would guess off the top of my head, I'm not sure, but I highly doubt that poor black people, let's keep it real. If you robbing people, black or white, you poor.
Yes.
You poor. Only broke motherfuckers rob people.
Right.
You got money, you ain't got to rob nobody.
Mm-hmm.
You broke, so you robbing people to get bread.
Mm-hmm.
So these are poor people. They're coming into other neighborhoods with people that got and they ain't getting much. You're getting people that got a little something, hitting them over the head, taking what they got, and running.
Mm-hmm.
So these are poor people robbing people who are working class people.
Yeah, I get you.
And they're in close proximity. It's not an Asian and black thing. It's not an Asian hate thing. It's a poor people robbing vulnerable people,
mm-hmm.
who doesn't have the protection of the police.
Yeah.
Who actually pretty much in the same position.
It's convenience crime.
Yeah. I like that. Convenience crime.
I fucking hate this subject. I hate this shit.
Me too, because it's kind of simple to break down what it is.
Stupid. Yeah, that's why I couldn't really say much because it's like, damn, like, what do you...
No, because I'm like, you're half Asian, so like...
No, not you. Oh. I'm saying like, I'm talking about like the people that have made it such a big thing.
Yeah.
You get what I'm saying?
Like, what the fuck is it?
Like,
what's this leading up to? This feels a little George Floydish.
Facts. Like, what are we gonna do? Asian Lives Matter.
Yeah.
Yeah, I see your boy China Mac getting involved.
Like,
missing jibs. Like,
hold on, like,
it's just because he's Asian.
No, I'm just saying, like, this shit feels mad.
Orchestrated.
Yeah, staged. It feels not even staged. It feels like, what's the word, man? There's a fucking word for this.
What are you
shit.
Trying to say?
What do they call artists? Plants. Plants. Oh. That's what it feels like. It feels like a plant. Mm-hmm. Feels like it's planted there for us to react. Because I don't know. It's like I feel this shit now. It's at a point where I've seen it enough times.
You know,
and seeing the phases of it, it just feels like what
it's
the
funny
fuck,
you say man? That. And it sounds
is this shit even
up?
Really
it
happening?
It sounds fucked up because we sound like we have like
we're dismissing their issue.
Yeah, yeah, like
yeah,
we don't care.
You know what's crazy?
And I'm Asian.
Nah.
And it sucks, bro. It sucks to even talk about that because that's the way I feel about the.
We sound insensitive.
Yeah, but
I don't want to sound insensitive. That's the way I feel about the Colorado shooting.
Because we see so many of them.
No, it's just the attention. It's just that it just happened, like Colorado shooting. Hey, let's ban assault rifles. It's like, all right. It's like, hey, let me listen. we knew Trump did and didn't do things. And I hate to make it political, but I think everything is a ploy. Just like people would argue that George Floyd was orchestrated. Mm-hmm. It's like, I'm not saying, I don't want to ever think that a shooting was orchestrated, yeah. right? I don't ever want to say that out loud. Mm-hmm. But banning of assault rifles was something that Trump was definitely against. Mm-hmm. Republicans as a whole, not with that shit. It's like, hey, let's show our power as Democrats that we're about change. But you can't just say, let's ban assault rifles. You need a reason to do it. Mm-hmm. You see what I'm saying?
Nah, I don't think we need a reason.
No.
But he's saying that's what they're saying to get people to agree with it.
Gotcha. You would have to have a valid reason. Like, listen, we had enough mass shooters, and now look what just happened again.
Right. Got you. I'm with you.
That's why he said it should be a partisan agreement. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Nonpartisan thing.
Yeah.
So it's all nasty to me. Like I said, I don't think it's, like I said, once again, Asians don't fuck with blacks, and blacks don't fuck with Asians. And that's just the way it is. Mm-hmm. Period, point blank. The Asians stick to their own.
But you know what's crazy, though? Like, me growing up, I've always seen, and even in the culture, Asians and blacks mesh. To me, I've never seen the segregation at all. And I've never seen... Really? Never.
It's really older Asians, younger Asians.
Yeah, I'm saying older Asians, yeah, that's normal because, it, like I said, traditional.
Right, that's why you got a Chinatown. That
falls into the white supremacy.
Right.
White supremacy is still an old idea.
Right.
It's mm-hmm. just certain young white people inherit white supremacist
right.
ideals.
Well, I don't think it's white supremacy if you come from somewhere where that's all you know is your race. They're
right,
not
you can't
used,
practice white supremacy if there's no white
people. There's no white people, so they don't know anybody but Asians.
Well, I believe...
No, we're talking about when they get to America.
Yeah,
but obviously when they get to America, everyone's looking at them crazy, like, because they're from a third world country to them. You know, they don't...
But are we looking at them crazy?
I feel that, yeah, because like you said... Off rip, they're vulnerable because they don't speak the language that you speak.
In 2021, well, yeah, that's true.
Think about it. There's mad nail salons that the owners that have been there for years, their English is still kind of fucked up.
It ain't even just the English. We do look at Asians sideways.
Well,
sideways.
But also,
yeah, I've seen it a lot.
But I will
people.
Say this:
the track record is crazy.
Asians, and I don't want to go too in on Asians.
Right.
But Asians definitely subscribe to the white supremacy. Not the white supremacy to the effect that black people are inferior. You can see that with what's going on in Africa. They go over there.
Yeah, I was gonna bring
they
that.
Buy up all the African, the economy and the industrial shit. And they do put a lot of money in the African economy.
Okay.
So yeah, it would appear that black people are flourishing. When in reality, China's flourishing. Mm. Really flourishing off that, over that market. And they treat the Africans like shit.
Yeah, let's not forget about that.
They
whole,
treat them like fucking shit.
The how they was kicking all black people out of malls and all that shit.
Yeah, they treat
allowing
them, like
them
shit.
To go certain places, beating that. This is last year. This is
right.
2020.
This is now happening over there in Africa. So,
let's not,
but there's some places
in China too. In China,
right? We talked about in that China, during the coronavirus.
Yeah,
and then they flipped it. The Chinese was actually blaming coronavirus on the Africans.
Yeah.
Remember, we talked about that.
And using that to abuse them.
Well, yeah, they was beating the shit out of them, making them homeless, kicking them out of their apartments in China.
We talked about that.
Well, they're allies, aren't they?
Oh,
no. Africans? And
no,
Chinese?
Of the U.S.?
No, they're communists.
Nah.
We got beef with China.
They just,
but I'm pretty sure they're very well connected because of a lot of...
Financially. They
own financially.
Us.
So... Right. Think about it. It would make sense for at least the U.S. to have some kind of influence on what they got going on in their country.
Right.
So.
Import-export shit.
Yeah.
We need them just as much as they need us.
Yeah.
But we need them way more.
Right.
We need China way more.
But that to me would make more sense as to why there is so much more white, you know, like Asians under white supremacy.
Well, the Asian white supremacy thing would...
You get what I'm trying to say?
But also... The powerful part of the U.S. is our army.
Yeah, I get you.
We'll fuck you up.
Yeah.
At the end of the day, that's what it boils down to. Like, who can beat who if some shit popped off?
Mm.
China would lose.
For sure. Okay, y'all might have army, but they got missiles. They got bombs.
They
got mad people.
But here's my thing. The people don't matter. Because one bomb would wipe the motherfuckers out.
It don't.
my thing about war, U.S.
They got nuclear weapons.
That doesn't matter because U.S. were there already.
I get, yeah.
See what I'm saying? Like,
U.S. got shit on lock.
The ships is in the water. So it's like the minute you shoot some shit, boom, we shooting it out.
Facts.
You can sit, because the intercontinental ballistic missiles go through space and come back down.
That was a lot of syllables.
The fact that he knows this, but go ahead.
A lot of syllables.
Yeah, yeah.
It's collective.
Intercontinental
missiles. It's crazy. It's real crazy.
That's the way it works. This is why U.S., if you think about it, right? Watch this. When you think of powers of other countries, they only have representatives and diplomats here.
Mm-hmm.
And you think about it, like my daughter, for instance, she'd be like, hey, I'm going to France. I'm like, for what? Why are we in France?
Yeah.
Why are we in Germany? Why are we in Italy? Why are we in Japan? You know why? What does all those countries have in common? Those are countries that we defeated in war. Once we defeat them, we stay. We occupy. We set up bases. There's thousands of troops in these places.
Mm-hmm.
There's thousands of ships and battleships in the water. We're there just in case some shit pop off.
Mm-hmm.
So it's like, all right, nigga, we could go to war with you, but you're going to lose before the war even start.
Yeah.
Go ahead, pop, nigga. We here already. We don't need an intercontinental ballistic missile.
Mm-hmm. Yo.
We don't need an intercontinental ballistic missile. An intercontinental ballistic missile shoot from your country to my country.
That's crazy.
What about my nuclear that I have 50 miles from you?
Yeah.
No army on planet Earth has anything around the U.S. They can't touch us. Mm. We set it up that way. That's why I feel safe being. Like, ain't nothing popping off. That's why 9/11 had to happen the way it happened. Inside job, maybe.
Maybe. Wow.
For sure.
No, I'm just saying.
I'll give you maybe.
Right. No, we know what it is.
For sure.
Listen.
Facts.
No, listen. Let's subscribe to what the masses think.
That was nasty.
Let's subscribe to what the masses think, just for the sake of conversation. We know what it is.
For the masses, it's a maybe. Yeah.
Well, all right. Let's subscribe to what they said happened.
Okay.
Right. So, and the only way to attack America would either be from the inside or to be here already. Or to hijack a plane or some shit like that. But your army ain't getting over here.
Right. Okay.
But wink, wink, we know what's up. You know what I mean? Like, with 9/11. You know what I mean? But
Sand nigga eyes?
What?
Yeah.
What'd you do?
Yeah, I did. I seen it.
Yeah, no, I didn't want to give the camera too much energy on it.
Right.
What are you saying? FBI knocking at the door. We got two more things to cover. We can get up out of here. First of all, Brooklyn and Five. LeBron is out indefinitely.
I heard about that.
What happened?
I mean, he's out for the season.
He's injured.
He got a high ankle sprain. Mm-hmm. Low ankle sprain, light work. He got a high ankle sprain.
He's going to be back for the playoffs?
For sure. He'll be back. But they're going to go into the playoffs as the lower seed. Which don't even matter in basketball.
That's how you know he's starting to get a little human.
I'm
not even going to say older. He's starting to get human.
LeBron don't get hurt.
Yeah, he's different.
He don't get hurt. Yes, he got a high ankle sprain. And I don't know when the playoffs start because the season's kind of weird this year, but it's starting pretty soon.
It's a little weird.
Yeah. So LeBron, I'm going with Brooklyn. That sucks. I'm going with Brooklyn anyway. I'm thinking Brooklyn. I know Brooklyn gonna take it this year.
I don't know.
Are you saying Brooklyn Lakers though? For the East, you think Brooklyn is definitely going?
If let's say there's a LeBron issue, right? He's out. First of all, I haven't watched basketball in like 2 months, but I would assume it hasn't changed too much.
Right.
So I would go with a Denver Nuggets or a Dallas Mavericks.
Okay, but on the East.
Over Brooklyn.
On the East, who you think going? Going.
Oh, shit.
Not winning. Who going?
Oh, who going on the East?
Because on the East, you really got nobody. You got Boston. You got Brooklyn. Who else?
What's up with Giannis?
They ain't getting past Brooklyn. That's all they got is Giannis. Timberwolves?
I didn't see these men play in the playoffs yet, man. You know me. I move as fast as the information.
Giannis just lost.
I haven't seen these three. I'm saying I haven't seen these three in the playoffs. I know that.
Oh, they looking good.
I know that in the playoffs.
Okay,
come on, you know how that goes.
Got you.
Shit get different, man. You know what I'm saying? It get different. You know, KD, we know his past when he's not on a team with the greatest shooters of all time.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? So we're going to see what he's like without a Steph Curry, Klay Thompson next to him. Who else is on there? Kyrie, Kyrie's inconsistent than a motherfucker.
Not lately.
in the playoffs.
Oh, okay, I got you.
Yeah, he's inconsistent in the playoffs like a motherfucker.
Okay.
I don't even gonna talk about your man.
Harden?
Nigga that ain't even dunking like 2 years.
Oh, he just caught one crazy. Oh, they got...
Is it crazy?
I forgot we got Blake Griffin.
Was it crazy?
You know Blake Griffin on Brooklyn now?
He said we. So was it...
I'm from Brooklyn.
Was it crazy? Was it crazy?
Yeah.
He caught a crazy dunk. Yeah. I like Blake Griffin. I always liked him. Always liked him.
You know he got a brother in the NBA? A lot of people don't know that.
No, I didn't know that. But,
right, that's crazy. He got a brother in the NBA.
And who's the other
trash
guy?
Trash, though.
Who's missing? Oh, Harden.
Harden.
Now, Harden's last playoff run was pretty solid.
Houston.
Yeah, his last one was pretty solid. So I think Harden might be playoff ready. You know what I mean? If he's not still fat. Did he lose weight yet?
Bro, I think he was just bloated. I think the guy IBS.
Harden got fat.
You think he had IBS? You know,
bro, the next day he was in shape again, bro.
You know IBS when you see it?
Yeah, I think he had IBS.
That's funny.
I think he faked being out of shape. The next day, the nigga was buff again. He's back in shape. How the fuck that happened?
Back in shape? Okay.
I think he like me. He got IBS.
Water weight? Maybe he was just drinking.
Probably.
Just had to piss.
I got that shit. I'll be fat as hell one day.
Your chicks just had to piss.
Nigga, I'll be fat as hell one day. Next day, six pack. Nigga, like, how the fuck you do that?
Yeah, that's crazy. Yeah.
IBS, bro.
Overnight type shit.
I don't know if y'all want to talk about it. It might be a lengthy conversation. I just want to know how y'all feel about it. Bad Baby. Shit she got going on. I don't got enough research.
What she got going on?
I mean, there's nothing really to say. It's just...
Yeah, but I mean, do we subscribe to her trying to defend somebody? It's like this. Bad kids.
Yo, you're peeking.
Bad kids. Her thing was the girl with the... Now, there was a girl there that came forward, and they said she was reprimanded for it. She said she was sexually abused. Okay. So Bad Baby came to give her testimony. It wasn't to say, hey, I've been sexually abused too.
She said she used her.
It was harsh treatment of kids there. What the fuck do you think is supposed to happen? We saw you on Dr. Phil, shorty. Like, you needed to be.
What was her example of harsh treatment?
They had the whole buckets for long periods of time, scrub shit. Like, hey, it's kind of jail. Like, yeah, I'm not against that.
Mm-mm. Yeah, get your scrub on. Scrub some shit.
It was really rough with them. And she thinks the place should be closed down.
Like what?
Sexual abuse is definitely 100% a reason to shut something down. But her reasoning for it to be shut down didn't have nothing to do with the girl's story.
Yeah.
Like,
she's don't give a celebrity your testimony. That went to the place and it made sense for them to bring her in.
When that girl turns 18, bro,
that's what we would.
Everything done. Coming off. I'm calling it sex tape immediately. First year, she turned 18 this year too.
Sex, yeah, she be wildin', so.
Yeah, for sure. All right, enough of Bad Baby. Last thing, why am I saying last thing? Like, we got to fucking schedule something. yo, I don't understand why this is, but how do you even do that? So, Jack Dorsey, right? Y'all know who Jack Dorsey is, right?
No.
Jack Dorsey owns Twitter.
Oh, okay.
Right? His first tweet, the first tweet ever sold. The first tweet that ever was sent out.
Soulja Boy, right?
It sold. No, he put out the first tweet.
Oh.
It sold for $2.9 million. The tweet, which said, just setting up my Twitter, was first published on March 21st, 2006, and auctioned off by Mr. Dorsey for charity.
Who the fuck would buy a tweet?
Bro, am I able to just go to 2006 and screenshot it?
No, you could retweet that shit.
I don't understand the value.
I'm befuddled.
Bro, I don't get I try to read through it. Could any of y'all smart people?
Why would anybody?
What's the value of a digital text?
Well, okay, hold on.
Is there an imprint?
Hold on.
Is there some type of something that makes it?
Well,
official.
Remember, think about when people get verified and shit like that.
Yeah, maybe
it comes with something.
The tweet, maybe it comes with a...
And maybe it comes with
some type of certificate or something. That's all it takes. All
right, well, here it is. The tweet, what you're saying, just said on Twitter, was first published March 21st, 2006, and was auctioned off by Mr. Dorsey for charity. The Malaysian-based buyer, Sina Estavi, compared the purchase to buying a Mona Lisa painting. The tweet was bought using either cryptocurrency or rival to Bitcoin. It was sold as a non-refungible, I don't know what the fuck that means, non-refungible token.
Spell that, please.
N-O-N-F-U-N-G-I-B-L-E. Non-refungible.
What?
I have no idea what that means.
Fuck?
Yeah. This is crazy. It was sold as a non-refungible token, NFT, on Monday to Mr. Estavi, the chief executive of technology firm Bridge Oracle. Our NFT, I'll tell you this. Our NFT is a unique digital certificate that states who owns a photo, video, or other form of online media.
The certificate.
Each NFT is unique and acts as a collector's item that can't be duplicated, making them rare by design. NFTs have become highly popular this year, with expensive digital artwork also being sold this way. Mr. Dorsey said he would convert the proceeds to Bitcoin and then donate them to Give Directly Africa Response Fund. Pandering. This is not just a tweet, Mr. Sterry posted on Twitter. I think years later, people will realize the true value of this tweet, like the Mona Lisa painting. Bro. I think it's the dumbest shit I've ever heard in my life.
Hold on, but did they say that they bought it in cryptocurrency?
Yeah.
What?
Cryptocurrency is just a rival to Bitcoin.
No, I know, but why? I don't know. That's weird.
I guess he views it as some kind of artwork, like some value. But this is the thing. People who spend these levels of money on things like this, they know where the world is going.
How much?
Nobody spends that much money.
Unless they knew they why know what's up. How the much value.
How much did it sell for you?
$2.9 million.
And so they're really paying for the certificate.
Right. So there's value in these things. You know what I'm saying? Like, if you look at Bitcoin, for instance, I wish I would have been well-versed in these things. Bitcoin a couple of years ago was only $40, $50.
Mm-hmm.
A Bitcoin now is worth $30,000.
Mm-hmm.
That's crazy. So the people who got ahead on these things, oh, they living nice right now. This is a big, huge reason why people like Jay-Z, Nas, they made investments in these things early in the stages, and they cashing out. So this is the wave of the future, y'all.
Facts.
Hey, this was a long show. We better than Joe Biden,
because it's a long show.
No, because the show was 100% entertaining from the beginning to the end. We flew it like.
We did have a fire episode.
We had a fire, and the whole shit was informative.
Facts.
Wasn't no veering off to the side to talk about a sexcapade or, you know what I mean?
A sexcapade.
Except for Derek Jackson's bullshit, but
hey,
we stuck to the script the whole time.
Very engaging.
And we look better than y'all.
Facts. Definitely better than Maul.
Maul is mug.
She jumped on Maul.
Maul is mug. No, I saw a video of Maul.
I would love to hug him. He just looks mug. Like he would hug right.
Hug right.
Nah, Maul got a dope ass personality.
Yeah, he do. He look like a sweetheart.
Yeah, go ahead. But I don't like. No, I think Maul is the way he is.
And I'm Rory, so I'm sensitive. And you're Joe. That makes all the sense.
And he hates Joe.
And you hate Joe. Obviously, they would hate each other if they're similar.
No, I think if me and Joe met, we'd be like really close.
Yeah, but y'all are very similar.
No, I'm not as emotional as he is.
Not in that sense, but y'all have similarities.
Right, he's a Virgo. I'm a Capricorn. Mm-hmm. So, but naturally, we would blend because, you know, Virgos and Capricorns kind of, he's my soulmate.
Oh.
You know what I mean?
Don't ever put two soul things twin together and say you and
a nigga soulmate.
He's like, which is my soulmate?
I don't know.
What is this? What's happening here?
Y'all got anything else?
No.
I got to download the goddamn thing. I still ain't do it.
God damn it, bro.
Anyways, y'all, this is episode 110. We on 110, y'all.
Chinks, you singing it.
Oh,
You know the words right now.
Me and Pyrex.
So episode 110 is in the books. We will be back next week. Y'all got any special announcements, anything like that?
Mm-mm. Nah, man.
Hell no.
Stay tuned for my next birthday, business
happy
venture.
Happy birthday, Pops.
Oh, your dad.
By the time it's come out, yeah, it'll be his birthday.
Oh, happy birthday.
Happy birthday.
Happy birthday, Big Quasi.
Mr. Anderson.
But he told me he had something to tell you, though.
No, he didn't.
Yes, he did.
Sound like Snoop.
Nigga, you a bitch.
What?
You not my dad. You also hear something.
Hold on.
So he's telling you that.
Why did we both guess that it was nigga, you's a bitch?
That's crazy. But it's that one.
Obviously, it's that one.
That was crazy.
Anyways, y'all. Episode 110 in the books. Know what I mean? Signing off right now. I'm getting a little lit from these fucking Trulies, too. They get to me. You know they got a new one? Truly, we're going to try them next week. They got Truly iced tea.
I crash on them.
On some Arnold Palmer shit?
Yeah, it's like the fruit iced tea, though.
Okay.
I want to
get it. It gets me tipsy, and then I crash.
Yeah.
It's the sugar.
Does that every time to me.
It's the sugar.
I'm like,
and also, you just finished smoking, so that probably helped.
Maybe. Yeah.
A little bit. Anyway, episode 1 of 10 in the book. Shout out to Fredo Cash. You know what I mean? Baltimore, stand up.
Ayy.
All jokes aside, baby, once in. Ayy.
Me and Pyrex together. Watch two worlds collide.
Me and Jackie bored out the sweets. You got hella holes inside. Whoa.
I'm the shit. Bitch, all jokes aside.
I look mad funny on camera. Shit. Bitch, all jokes aside. 110 in the books.
It ain't going. None of that's going to show.
I know.
It's going to be your elbows.
Till next week, y'all.
I said
bye.
Whoa. Fredo. I love that. I love that. Me and Pyrex together. Watch two words collide. Me and Jackie boiled out the sweets when we got hella whores inside. Whoa. I'm the shit. Bitch, y'all jokes aside. I'm the shit. Bitch, y'all jokes aside. Me and Pyrex together. Watch two words collide. Me and Jackie boiled out the sweets when we got hella whores inside. Whoa. I'm the shit. Bitch, y'all jokes aside. I'm the shit. Bitch, y'all jokes aside. I'm the shit. Need a nigga, I had to say more. Ain't nobody gonna do it like this. Coming out of body more. I know Jackie got some moves. I know Pyrex got some moves. Trying to get these niggas share they bitches, cause I'm so sick of fucking yours.